away. The Huskies were a prohibitive favorite, but somebody forgot to tell the home team. Truth, there was a questionable call on what appeared to be a touchdown pass for Washington, and Chuck Nelson had his only field goal miss of the year. But the Cougars simply ran over the Huskies. Two running backs gained over 100 yards, and when State needed the big defensive play, it got it. They carried Jim Walden off the field that day, and they carried the goalposts all through the town. The Cougars had won 24-20. Time, though, heals all wounds.
And when the Huskies had the home field in last year's game, again it was for the Rose Bowl. And again, the Huskies were favored. And they had something to prove. This time, the curse of the Palouse took its act on the road. Defense was the order of the day for the Cougars, who came to Seattle on a four-game roll. Washington State had it going, but beating the favorite Huskies two straight out of the Rose Bowl, that was another story. But they did. When the dust, or the mud as it were, had settled, the Cougs had done it again, 17-6. The Cougars have won four straight. They're underdogs, and there are bowl bids riding on the outcome of this one today. Washington State wants a hat trick. Huskies visiting the Washington State Cougars. Important adjective of all, electric. That describes the mood here at Martin Stadium in Pullman, Washington, as two cross-state rivals who don't much care for each other have at it with a bowl berth at stake on both sides. Hello, everybody. I'm Barry Tompkins once more along with Jack Snow, and we have made a long trek through this Pac-10 conference this year. We've come to the end of it now. Traditional rivalry, bowl berth at stake, and after today's activities all around the country, bowl berths are really up for grabs, Jack.
There's no question about it. Today's a big game for both these schools. Number one, they want the bragging rights within the states, but also the Orange Bowl committees and the Fiesta Bowl committees are both in attendance this afternoon.
Everybody's looking at Washington. Everybody's looking at Washington State, too. What about the players? How do they feel about this one? They feel pretty much as you would expect.
Well, the importance of the game to me is the difference between being 10-1 and 9-2 this year.
This year, we're playing for a lot of pride, and when you play against your crosstown rivals, you know, you need to go home and be able to live in your town and say that you won.
Kind of a character check of our team to see if we can bounce back and beat the Cougars this week.
A lot of people talk about bowl games, but I think for the Cougars, who have ever been a Cougar and who are Cougars now, this is really the bowl game. I want to go out a winner. Can't lose to the Huskies.
The team's going to win. It's going to be the Washington State Cougars for the third year in a row.
It's 41 degrees here and dropping. I really don't think any of the fans here at Martin Stadium know about the temperature. Anticipation right now is the order of the day. We'll be back to talk with the coaches right after this. A couple of minutes this side of kickoff. The game between the Washington State Cougars and the visiting Washington Huskies. What about these teams? Well, Washington, we know, lives by its defense. Washington State lives by its offense. Let's talk about the Huskies' defense. It is anchored, no question, by Ron Holmes. What a game he had against USC, as his coach, Don James, is quick to agree.
I think Ron Holmes probably was the best football player on the field last week. He just had a great game. He played against a lot of their linemen. He gave second effort. He hit hard, and he competed until the very last play. And I thought it was probably one of the best performances I've ever seen in one of our players.
I think one of the remarkable things, Jack, is that Holmes had that kind of game against an all-conference performer that he was playing head up on.
He did. You know, the offensive line of the Trojans is outstanding. We look at Ron Holmes. You know, 20 tackles last week against the Trojans. He'll be wearing number 90, 6'4", 255-pound senior. There he is right there knocking the ball. Outstanding defensive end for the Huskies.
Now, when we see him today, well, you're going to see him all over the place. He's not going to line up on any one guy.
Well, they want to utilize his talent. They're going to move him all over the field. He may play left defensive end, right defensive end. We wouldn't be surprised to see him play a little bit of nose guard today, too.
All right, Washington State, they live by the offense, and the offense is as good as the quarterback. The quarterback is Mark Rippon. He's a junior. He has really started to come into his own over the last five games, and Jim Walden is quick to talk about the man who will be throwing the ball.
Well, I think Mark Rippon means everything to it. I think, you know, he handles the ball on every play, and it starts with him and so much of everything we're trying to do. Centers around him. Reuben Mays is a person who has benefited from the threat of Mark Rippon. Mark can throw the ball. He's showing people now he can execute our option game. And really right now, he is in great tempo. He's an excellent athlete, a big athlete, a guy who has great confidence. And really and truly, I think he's the best athlete in this conference as a quarterback. And we're only as good as Mark Griffin's ability to play. If we win, it'll be because of Mark Griffin.
And, Jack, there is a question mark about Mark Griffin. He dropped a glass on his hand. It took 15 stitches. It's ugly. Let's put it that way. It is very much of a question mark today. He hasn't taken a snap all week.
Look at that. That looks very, very gruesome. There's no question of it. And you're right. He has not taken a snap, but he has thrown the ball every day this week during practice. I mean, it makes you sick. You look at that hand right there.
Now, they are telling us it will not affect the performance of Mark Griffin. Whether or not that's the case still remains to be seen. Griffin has got to be considered before the kickoff. A question mark. We'll know after the first few snaps just how much damage that hand will be able to take. We'll be back right after this. So turn it loose tonight by Nissan. We're changing our name from Datsun to Nissan. Known for high quality cars and trucks for 50 years, Datsun is now Nissan. By PSA, famous for our frequent flights and low fares. Catch our smile. By National Car Rental, you deserve national attention. And by Dodge, a performance revolution, an American revolution. And we are back. The Washington Huskies, the visitors, have won the toss. And rather unusual, Jack, they have elected to receive. We haven't seen too much of that this year.
Normally we see them give it up
and take the option in the second half. So the Cougars will kick it off. Washington will try it on offense for the first time. There's a look at the way the series stands. It is, of course, one of the oldest series on the Pacific Coast. We have had all the traditionals today. Oregon, Oregon State, USC, UCLA, Stanford, and Cal. And now, of course, Washington State and Washington. You get a good look at John Trott, number four. He'll be kicking to Lonzel Hill and Danny Green. And listen to the crowd already. Line drive kick for Trott. Tough to handle. Bounces in and out of the end zone. Huskies will start at the 20. Sicaro will be the quarterback for the Washington Huskies. Now, the last time we saw them, of course, it was Hugh Millen. Millen went all the way for the first eight games. Then in the second half of the game against Oregon, Sicaro came off the bench and led the Huskies to victory, despite the fact they only had three first downs in that football game. So the Huskies come to the line of scrimmage for the first time. Crowd in this ball game right from the opening snap. Jack Robinson, the up back. This is Robinson with the move to the 25, to the 29-yard line. Gain of nine on first down. Rico Tipton runs him down. Here's the way the Huskies line up across the line. Sicaro, the quarterback, with Hunt and Robinson, who has really come along in this, his final year at Washington. The receiver's solid. Danny Green, very good deep threat. Mark Patterson, possession receiver. He is a good one. Offensive line, always a strong point of the Washington Huskies. Second and short now for the Huskies. Almost a free play here for Sicaro. Slot right. Sicaro, straight ahead. Robinson into the open. 40, 45 to the 46-yard line. Big yardage up the middle on two successive plays. Ricky Reynolds, the tackler for the Cougars.
Washington's going to have to shore that middle of that defensive line up a little bit. I mean, Washington's getting away with a lot right now.
Here's the way the Cougars line up defensively. The down three, Milford Hodge coming off what might have been his best game as a collegiate a week ago. Lee Blakeney, the senior linebacker, the anchor of that core. Ricky Reynolds, a good ball game last week in the secondary. Sicaro to pass for the first time. Wide open out of the backfield. Robinson, midfield, 45, 40, 35, out of bounds the 31-yard line.
Watch it again now right here. He's going to drop back. He's looking to his right. He's going to stay all the way. He's looking for Jock, who runs just a little shoot pattern out into the flat. He's all alone right there. Boom, gets a good block from his outside receiver, number 19, Mark Patterson, turns up the sideline, a tackler misses him. Look at that. This is a big ball game for the Huskies. They've got a lot to prove today. Their dobber's been down all week, but they want to play and have a good game today and come away with a victory.
Patterson came off the field with an injury. He is replaced by Lonzel Hill. They do not drop off a great deal with Hill in the ball game. In motion this time goes Green. This is fullback Hunt. He gets the 35 to about the 32-yard line. Lee Blakeney makes the stop. Washington offensive line is really pumped, getting off the ball very well right now.
They're coming off. They're blowing Washington State back off the line of scrimmage. And what can happen or what can't happen for the Cougars is the Cougars defense has got to control the Huskies today if they want the hopes of winning this ball game.
I said Hunt, the ball carrier, last time. He was replaced by Finney. It was Finney, number 30, the ball carrier. So it is Finney and now Cookie Jackson in the ball game, the up-back spot in the I formation. Slot left. This is Jackson, left side. Jackson slips by one man to the 30, down to the 29-yard line. Lee Blakeney, the tackler. Ball at the 29-yard line. It'll be third and short now for the Washington Huskies, who have shown a lot of offense early in this football game. Two tight ends now, as on the sidelines, Jim Walden getting a little bit of an equipment repair. Green, the lone wideout in the ball game. Chuck Robinson back in the game at tailback. This is Robinson, right side. First down and more, 25, 20. Good, tough running by Jacques Robinson. Kevin Cogan leading the way. Lee Blakeney and Cedric Brown, what might have been a saving tackle for the Cougars. And Patterson is back on for the Huskies, so obviously that injury, nothing to worry about for Husky fans.
Going to be a quick pitch here to Robinson. Watch 72 come out and get a block right there. Kevin Cogan, the right tackle, makes an excellent block. 28, Robinson busted in the secondary right there, keeps his feet, gets a little extra yardage.
Slot left this time, Danny Green in the slot. First down, Cougars, ball at the 19-yard line. Green in motion, and somebody jumped, I believe it was Al Robinson. Left guard offensively for the Washington Huskies, and that'll cost them five. Robinson now three carries, 36 yards.
Let's see if we notice any movement. There it is right there. Yeah, good call, no question about it.
Robinson, senior from Bellevue. Started out his career at Washington as a walk-on. Got off the ball a little bit quick that time. So it'll be first and 15. Just one pass in this drive so far. Cooper Jackson now the up back in the I formation. This is Jackson at the right side. Jackson about the 23. Gain of about two. That time the Cougars were up to it defensively. Eric Howard and Brent White on the down three for the Washington State Cougars. First time they have managed to contain.
Washington has been very, very impressive so far. Granted, it's a little over 11 minutes to go in the ball game in the first quarter. But well, they've maintained it very, very well.
It's also exactly what Don James had told us he needed to do when we talked to him last night. He said he's got to keep his offense on the field and his defense off of it. This is Jack Robinson, caught from behind by Milford Hodge. Good defensive play by Hodge.
They moved Milford from the nose last week over to the right defensive end. He's an outstanding athlete, very quick, very aggressive, and they want to utilize his talents.
So it'll be third down and 14, passing down for Sicaro. Patterson to the near side. Green to the far side. Straight back, Sicaro. Throws to the right side. And that is Danny Green, and he'll be short of the first down. Make that Roten. Short of the first down. That'll bring on the field goal team as Jeff Jaeger comes on. And the Cougars have stiffened up suddenly here.
I think Sicaro wanted to run, he had his receiver, Mark Patterson, number 19, running a corner route. He tried to go to Mark, but fortunately he did, and he came back in and dumped it off the road. And heads up play by Sicaro.
So this will be about a 33-yarder for Jaeger, well within his range. Snap, place, kick. And this one is plenty good. Probably would have made good from 53. Jeff Jaeger puts it through, and the Washington Huskies have put points up on their first offensive efforts. The Cougars have yet to get the football, and the Huskies have used 4.5 minutes of the clock. That is what Don James wanted to do. So a timeout on the field with the scoreboard showing Washington 3 and the Washington State Cougars nothing. That the broadcast cablecast rights to this game are granted by Washington State University to TCS Metro Sports. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the written consent of Washington State University is prohibited. The announcers on this telecast have been hired and paid for by TCS Metro Sports in consultation with the Pac-10 Conference. So Jeff Jaeger will kick it off now following his 33-yard field goal. And at the other end, the deep man, Junior Tatatasi for Washington State. Jaeger, high end over end kick. Got a lot of this. It may get out of the end zone. It does not actually hit the back of the end zone. Just a touchback, and it won't come out to the 30. It'll come out to the 20. Couldn't have placed that any better. Here's a look at a man on the bubble right at the moment. He really doesn't know, I'm sure himself, Jack, how that's going to feel when he takes the first snap from center.
That's the big question mark. The fact is, he can throw the ball. There's no question of that because he's been doing it all week. The real problem is when that ball is jammed up there by the center. First time Ladina snaps that ball up into that hand, that's going to be the big question mark.
You can see he's wearing what amounts to a golf glove with the fingers cut out of it. And it does not affect his throwing at all. That part of the hand where the cut is does not touch the football. We'll talk a little bit more about that. In motion this time is James on first down. And Rippon gives it straight ahead. That's Mays fumbling the football, and the Cougars have it. A big break. It was Rogers that recovered the football. Rogers, number 39, off the fumble from Mays on the first snap, and the Cougars are, or rather the Huskies are in business.
That's a very, very big turnover for the Huskies. They're going to have to capitalize on that now, and it's going to be a big series for the Cougars of Washington State. They're going to have to try and shut them down.
Now, so far, everything going exactly the way Don James wanted it to go.
Watch him right here now. It's just a reverse fake. He comes back and hands off to Mays. Let's see what happens to the ball right here. Let's see if he's got to protect it as he goes through the line. Doesn't seem to be, there he goes. He loses it right there. It's a good shot. He's trying to get to it, but he just can't. A little bit late.
Jock Robinson on first down for Washington. Well, he gets a couple across the 35-yard line. Might have gotten the 34-yard line. White and Hodge in the center of the line defensively for Washington State make the tackle. Gain of almost four on that play, and that'll give you a pretty good indication as to just how the Washington offensive line is getting off the football, because Robinson didn't make any contact for 3 yards. Second and long seven, not a short seven. Straight ahead fullback Finney gets a couple down about the 32-yard line. It'll be a gain of about 2 yards on the play. It'll be third down and five, the entire center of the Washington State offensive line making the stop. Washington State, it does seem, is going to have to make some defensive adjustments. They did seem to make them once Washington got down deep in Cougar territory.
They tightened up a little bit. They took those linebackers and jammed the holes a little bit quicker. Don't let those linemen get too far out downfield to throw a block on them. You got to jam up the line of scrimmage.
They're down at five now for Paul Sicaro and the Huskies. Sicaro play fake. He'll throw. Rolls out. Downfield. That's Green, but he's out of bounds. And so it'll be fourth down, and Jaeger will come back on again. This one will be a little bit more of a test for Jaeger. We'll take another look at it, and you can judge for yourself. It did look clearly that Green was out, but let's see.
Take a look here at Danny, number 80. He's got to get that 1 foot down in bounds. He makes a nice reception there, no question. Good call by the officials. He's way out of bounds.
So this one will be just short of a 50-yarder. Jaeger made good on a 33-yarder a moment ago. Snap, place, kick. He's got enough, but it's off to the left. It'll be no good. So Washington State has jumped up and done the job defensively, and that should fire the Cougars up.
They'll get them hopping now. You know, they blew it the last time they had the ball by fumbling, and that's been a big part of Washington's success this year, is to capitalize on the opposition's turnovers, fumbles, interceptions, so forth and so on. Washington State does not want to get in the habit. They don't want to turn the ball over and give it to this Husky team, especially in this type of field position.
So Washington unable to come away with any points following the turnover on the first offensive snap for the Cougars. This is the second. They bring James in motion. Rippon with Mays and Calvin. That was Calvin straight ahead. And he got a yard or two, not much more than that. Reuben Mays was the ball carrier, beg your pardon, not Calvin. Now look at the way the Cougars line up offensively. We've talked about all those backs. Mays, of course, an outstanding one. Two good outside receivers. In fact, Washington State has four good outside receivers. Offensive line, I'll tell you, that is what brings them. An outstanding offensive line. That's James. Bounces off of Matt Calvin up to midfield to the 49-yard line. Richard Calvin from out of the backfield. Well set up play and a well thrown ball by Rippon.
Look at him. He's trying to get that bench of the Huskies jacked up. Let's get going here. Let's go. Let's move it. Watch him again right here now. You got to remember that Calvin 32 was going in motion. Rippon stops, or takes the snap, drops back and hits him direct. Lays her out there in the flat. Now put a good move on right here. Number 39 comes in there. That's Jimmy Rogers. Can't quite bring him down. Big play for the Cougars.
Nice play by Calvin. Also making that catch knowing you're going to get hit and still making the catch and managing to avoid being hit. First down for the Cougars. Straight ahead. First man. Mays fumbled and the Huskies have it. So Reuben Mays has coughed it up the first two times he's touched the football tonight. Tim Peoples has come away with this one. How do you like it?
It's amazing. It's utterly amazing. I think what happened is he's trying too hard. Mays may be trying a little bit too difficult. Big, you know, trying too hard too early in the ballgame. Let's look at it here. Big hole right in there. Just jumps through the hole in good fashion, but bang, he loses the ball. Gets knocked right out of his hand. I think it's Steve Alford, number 93, knocks the ball loose.
That time was stripped from him, unlike the first one, where it might have been incidental. That time, I think, was by design. So the Huskies have it again. They have had it most of this first period. We're not yet halfway through the first quarter. Sicaro, play fake, he'll throw. Being rushed. Now he has a man open. It's Lonzel Hill at the 38, down about the 32-yard line. So the Huskies doing it all right. James Krakowski makes the stop. He, of course, has a brother playing linebacker on the other side of the field for the Washington Huskies.
You're going to see Lonzo Hill, number one, come from the left over to the right of your screen. He's running a deep in route. He clears all the secondary, all the linebackers, gets over to the opposite side of the field, makes a catch before he's knocked down by 51, Jim Krakowski.
This time they split Tony Roten. They line Rod Jones up as the tight end. So Roten in the ballgame actually has a wide out here. Getting to Jack Robinson with room, 35, 25, 20, and out of bounds at about the 21. Stopped short of the 20-yard line, actually. Ricky Reynolds, the man who runs him out. So Jack Robinson showing a good ability to get into the open, and you got to credit his offensive line there.
He did. Look at this, six carries for 50 yards. But I'll tell you one thing, Roten, number 88, the man who went in motion that time, put a good block on two, Gerald Waters, a free safety of the Cougars, which definitely helped him pick up about 12 extra yards.
And once more, they split Roten. Sicaro now 3 of 5, 63 yards. First man through is Feeney across the 20 to about the 19-yard line. It'll be a gain of a couple, no more than that. James Krakowski makes the stop along with Brent White for the Cougars. On the sideline, Don James, rather impassive as he is wont to be. David Trimble in the ballgame is a wideout now, and now Jones leaves. Lonzel Hill comes on very late. So all sorts of confusion here. Sicaro yells the play out to him. Let's see if they can get it off in time. They got 6 seconds to get the play off, and they do easily. Play fake this time, in trouble, and Sicaro throws it away. Now we'll see, that's going to be grounded. That's going to cost him a whole bunch. Krakowski, the man coming on the blitz, had his arms all wrapped around Sicaro.
Good call by the Washington State defense. Del White, the defensive coordinator for Washington State. It's a good time for a blitz. You're going to see it right here. Now Sicaro's going to fake with his bare hand. He's going to roll out to his right, but here comes Krakowski, 51, in from the right-hand side. Now watch the ball right here. There's no question of it. He knows he's going down. That's a good call by the official. Good call by Larry Thompson's crew.
That will be marked also from the point of the foul, so it's going to come all the way back to the 38-yard line. You're going to need shots and a visa to make a first down from here.
Lose the down, too. That's important.
So it'll be third down and 27. Slot right with Green, slotted inside of Lonzel Hill. Roten back at tight end now. This is Robinson. Robinson gets by the first man, but not the second. He's wrapped up by Lee Blakeney, 96. And this time the Huskies will punt.
But Blakeney's had quite a career, especially in this senior season for him. 139 tackles so far this year, 2 tackles for losses and an interception. Great linebacker for the Huskies, for the Cougars.
So it'll be Thane Clellett. I'm on to do the punting for Washington. Ed Blunt is the deep man. I doubt very much he'll get a chance to return this. He stands at the 10-yard line. And the punt is high and twisting and angled for the sideline, and a good one. It's going to go out of bounds at about the 6-yard line. Excellent effort that time by Clellan, the punter. So a timeout of the field, 6:34 remaining here in the first period. It's a 3-0 ball game. The Huskies lead it.
money.
Martin Stadium in Pullman, Washington. Washington has had the ball virtually the entire first quarter, but they've only come up with 3 points. That could be a factor later, Jack.
It is. You know, they've had trouble offensively scoring a lot of points this year. Here's an example of the last two times that they had the ball. They've got to get better pressure.
Reuben Mays, two fumbles. The first two times he's carried the football. Rippon out of his own end zone, throws deep. And out in front was James, but Rippon just couldn't quite get the ball to him. James had a step.
He had him beat on the post pattern, no question of it. Ball just thrown just a little bit long.
J.C. Pearson, the man defending, but James was at least a step, step and a half in front of him. Would have had to be a perfect pass, but nevertheless, he was open.
Interesting, though, about the first quarter for the Washington Huskies. They have outscored their opponents 69-16. On the other hand, the Cougars have been outscored 41-43. So it's kind of playing to form so far in the first quarter.
Chase slots inside of Breland, and they bring Calvin in motion this time. Counterplay, and this is Mays. Mays gets into the open for a moment. Gets to about the 18-yard line. Confidence builder for Reuben Mays.
Absolutely. He wanted that ball that time. He hit that hole going 90 miles an hour. He's ready. I think he's back.
Tim Peoples, the man who made the stop. So that'll build his confidence. Here's a look at the way the Cougars line up on defense. Of course, Washington playing defense right now. So a first down for the Cougars at the 18-yard line. Their second. In motion this time comes number 82. That's Burris. And they give this time straight ahead to Calvin. Calvin gets across the 20, about the 21-yard line. Last week against the University of California, Washington State got better as the game went on offensively.
They got stronger and stronger. They looked a lot better. They had a couple of fumbles early in the ball game, if I remember correctly, which kind of slowed their offense down. And it's reminiscent of what's happened so far in this first quarter with the Cougars.
Joe Krakowski, the man who made the tackle that time. There are two Krakowskis here. One for Washington, one for Washington State. Both are linebackers, both very fine football players. Both from the San Francisco Bay Area, Fremont, California.
Both big.
Here's a give this time. Another counterplay to Mays, and Mays has another first down across the 30 to the 31. Tim Peoples makes the stop. Mays has truly had a remarkable year.
Great back, done some superb things this year.
He needed 92 yards coming into this game to take over sixth place on the Pac-10 single season rushing chart, that ahead of USC's Marcus Allen, and that's really quite a chore.
You watch him there as he hits the hole. He gets upfield real nice. He's brought down by 26, Tim Peoples, but I think that before the night's over that Reuben Mays is going to pop a long run.
Really does get to the hole in a hurry, I'll tell you. In motion this time goes Breland to the far side. The give this time at the right side. Here's Mays again, and Mays gets a couple that time. He's contained pretty well as Washington strung it out. Ron Holmes, number 90, and you just can't say enough about that man.
He's a great one. There's no question of that.
We expect to see Ron Holmes, in fact, playing, as we mentioned at the top of the program, all over. Not only head up on the tackler, head up on the guard, we expect to see him at the nose guard position on occasion. We'll try to keep an eye on him. In fact, that's where he is right now, right over the nose of the center. So it'll be second down and about 8. Rippon rolls left. Has a little time. Now he's got room to run. He does. 35 to about the 38-yard line. Gain of about 6 for Mark Rippon. Joe Kelly runs him down. Linebackers of the Washington Huskies. An outstanding group all across.
Very active group, Barry. You know, they make a lot of good plays. They make some interceptions. Beamber, Kelly, Fred Small, Reggie Rogers, Joe Krakowski. They're always moving. They're always in your face. They're filling holes. They're dropping back in their pass coverages. Good group.
Here's a big play now for the offense that is acknowledged by just about every coach that we've talked to as being the best in the Pac-10 conference right at the moment. The numbers, of course, bear that out. Third down and 3. Rippon the quarterback, Mays and Calvin. And now Calvin in motion out of the backfield. Rippon gives to Mays, and Mays cannot get by the first man. Great play by Joe Kelly. And the Cougars will have to give it up once more.
Try a little inside trap that last play. They got number 90, Ron Holmes, came flying by, but they couldn't get by Joe Kelly, number 36. Take a look at it right here. Dropped back, just hand off inside. Kelly's in there on a blitz, basically. He's running in the hole between the center and the guard. He meets the ball carrier right in the hole. Good job by Joe Kelly.
Glenn Harper comes on to do the punting for Washington State. He'll be kicking to a dangerous return man, Danny Green. We look for some surprises on the special teams of the Cougars tonight, and he really stuck this one. Drives Green back to the 9-yard line. Takes a step backwards. Gets by the first man. Now he's got a little room. Look out. 20, 25, 30. To about the 34-yard line. Great run by Danny Green. Jeff Loomis made what might be a saving tackle. Danny Green, the big return. It was about 31 yards. 2:55 remaining, first period. A lot of action in this football game. It's 3-0.
Shocked by the high cost of electric heat? You're a sensible person. Consider natural gas. It's abundant and costs less than electricity. This new high-efficiency gas furnace...
Strong part of the Washington State offense, or any part of the Washington State offense or defense so far this year. 32-yard average. As you look at what's coming up for us, basketball starting here on the TCS Metro Sports Network. We'll talk a little bit more about the punting as Jack Robinson has no place to go and runs out of bounds. Washington State had only been averaging 32 yards per punt. Harper stuck that one for 56. That's a vast improvement.
Well, yeah, you want to get that ball up in the air, and you want to, you know, the distance is great, but you want good hang time. You get good hang time, you allow your team to come down, cover the ball, and no return. They've only been netting 32 yards. That's net, which means you may kick a 40-yard punt, but the returner is going to run it back for 8 yards.
And in that case, Danny Green ran one back for 31. The three on first down. It's second and 13. Ball at the 32-yard line. Green in motion. And a little mix-up in there, and Robinson has nowhere to go. Back to the 28-yard line. Al Robertson, the man there who Sicaro ran into and then ran into Robinson. Sort of like bumper cars.
You know, this game is so full of emotion right here as we look at it again. These guys, sometimes they look like they're, look at that, they want to move so fast that they're bumping into each other. Al Robertson, the offensive left guard, bumps into his quarterback. And therefore, you know, basically ruins the play.
So it'll be third down and 17. Turning out to be a defensive football game here, very much to the chagrin of Washington State. Sicaro straight back to pass on 17. Has time. Now he pulls it back. Throws to Robinson. It's good to Robinson at the 30-yard line, but it'll be well short of the first down. About 15 yards short. A gain of 2. And the Cougars will get it back. As Thane Cleland comes on to do the punting for Washington.
He wanted to throw that ball downfield to Mark Patterson on a curl route, but couldn't do it. He had great coverage in there by 96, Lee Blakeney.
Blunt, the deep man, and the Cougars will now have the best field position, at least in theory, that they've enjoyed. Cleland almost has it blocked, and he was hit. That's going to be roughing. And the Huskies will be benefit of that penalty. Now, whether it was running into the kicker or roughing the kicker remains to be seen.
That's a very close call there. Sometimes it may even be an acting penalty on the kicker. You know, you can't act anymore. If you do, it's a penalty against the offense. Let's take a look at it right here now. Here's Thane Cleveland right there. Gets the ball off right there. There's no problem. Nobody around him. Let's see who comes in there. See if it's a good smack. Yeah, there's definite contact made, no question of that. Number 90 in there.
Tom Cushing was the man.
Cushing, the weak side linebacker, definitely hits him, there's no question. You know, they're afraid of a guy getting hit with his leg up in the air because a lot of damage can happen. Good call by Larry Thompson, the official.
And it'll be a first down for Washington. So instead of good field position for Washington State, the Huskies remain in possession of the football, and that has got to be good news for the folks in Seattle. Ball at the 45-yard line. That is a big break for Washington. They've had them all so far. Slot left, and now Green in motion. Sicaro gives once more to Robinson, gets by the first man, gets to about the 48-yard line, a gain of about 3, maybe 4 yards. Eric Howard, Rico Tipton on the tackle for the Cougars. Coming up at the end of the game, we'll be selecting a defensive player of the game. That award is always sponsored by our friends at National Car Rental. We thank them. It'll be second down and 7 now for the Washington Huskies. Ball short of the 49. Sicaro will put it up. Big rush over the middle. Wide open. That's Danny Green. He's got room. 40, 45. Got a great block there. Down about the 34-yard line. Tony Roten, the man who really leveled one of the Washington State Cougars, and that gave Green about another 10 yards.
Great route. Great footwork after the catch, too. You notice him. Here, as we take a look at him, Danny Green, number 80 right there. Watch him right here, right over the middle. Now watch him get the ball. You're going to turn off field, put a move on. Give him the step and take it away. Give the leg and tape it away. Good job by Danny Green. Number 20 comes in there. Ricky Reynolds makes a tackle. If he don't make the tackle right there, it's a touchdown.
Ball at the 34-yard line. First down, Huskies once more. Trimble in motion. And again a mix-up. This is Cookie Jackson, nothing doing. at the 33. Eric Howard has him. Howard's been all around the football so far tonight.
Playing well, there's no question about number 73, the big left defensive end. But going back to what we just saw, Al Robertson, 67, the left guard, he and Sicaro are having trouble. One of two things is happening. Either Sicaro isn't getting enough drop on his initial step, or Al Robertson is getting too deep a drop when he's pulling out of that right guard or that left guard position.
Remember, this is only the third game that Sicaro has started as we come to the end of the first quarter. So the end of the first 15 minutes of play. It has been an interesting football game. Washington leads it and is driving 3-0. Washington end of the first quarter, and Washington, which has had possession of the football virtually the entire quarter, as you can see by virtue of the numbers after the first quarter, leads the football game only 3-0. Going to be 2nd down and 9. Huskies driving again at the Cougar 33. Sicaro will put it up. He's 5 of 6. Throws over the middle. Man open. That is Patterson. Good to the 25-yard line. Gerald Waters makes the stop, and a flag is down. So it's going to cost Washington State a little bit more.
Looking at a late hit in there, I believe, Barry. Nice route, too, run by Mark Patterson.
And there you see, personal foul is the call. Larry Thompson, the referee, giving it to you.
Watch it right here. Let's see what happens. There he comes right in there very late. Looks like 26, Jeff Doolin, may have come in a little bit late there and lay the lumber on him.
Jim Walden is not at all pleased about all of this. Very emotional guy. He's got a very emotional team. He's emotional sitting in his office.
What he's telling the officials is Doolin came in there and stuck that receiver before he was down on the turf.
Try to get one back later. That's the intent of that. Green goes to the far side now on first down. Ball at the 13-yard line. Huskies have spent most of this football game in Cougar territory. Look in motion. This is Robinson. And he doesn't get much that time. Eric Howard once more makes the stop. Howard, just a junior out of San Jose. Don James on the sideline. Same look that he has just about any time I've ever seen Don James on a football field or off a football field.
I don't think he ever changes at all, ever.
Real calm, not real concerned about the goings-on. Doesn't really have any reason to be at the moment. His team has pretty much dictated this football game so far, even though they only lead by 3. Roten in motion on 2nd down and 9. And it gives to Robinson, left side, and Robinson is stopped at about the 9-yard line. He got about 4, maybe. Ricky Reynolds made the stop. Robinson just put his head into Reynolds' pads and knocked him back a couple more yards.
Jock's taken a little bit of heat coming into this year, I'll tell you, but he's had a good year this year. He's really excelled within himself, which has made him an excellent athlete, a better ball player than he's been since his freshman year at Washington.
But he burst into prominence as a freshman in the Rose Bowl against Iowa. And since that time, he's just had a real leveling off period. Ebbed perhaps last year. Big play, 3rd down, and about 6. Sicaro looks to the end zone, and a 5 defensive effort that time by Rico Tipton, who got a hand on the football before it ever got to Green. That was going to be a tough catch for Green no matter what. Good defense by the Cougars.
Cedric Brown, 16, was sitting right in there. Watch it right here now. He's going to come along the back of the end zone line. Danny Green is. There's a tip right there. Almost. No, I don't think he tipped it. Well, yeah, he did. It was close. But right here at the very end, too, 16, Cedric Brown, who was trailing Danny Green on the play, gets a hand up also.
And so Jager will come on to try a field goal. This will be a 25-yarder. Chip shot for him. They lead it 3-0. He'll try for 6. Snap, place, kick. And good. So the Huskies come away with 3 once more. And I'm sure the Cougars feel pretty good about just making it be only 3. 13 minutes, 19 seconds remaining to be played here in the first half. Huskies have owned the ball game so far, but they lead only 6-0. And also, as a matter of fact, Jager will kick it off, and we want to remind you that we're going to be having plenty of bowl coverage. First on December 26th, the Freedom Bowl from Anaheim, California. Washington State, in fact, giving some thought to being there, perhaps, if not there, in another bowl, should they win today. And then, on the 29th of December, the Aloha Bowl from Honolulu, Hawaii. Both games start at 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 Pacific. Check your local listings for the time and station in your area. Malatesi will be the deep man to receive this kick from Jaeger. Jaeger's 2 field goals is the difference in the ball game. He's 2 of 3 so far. And there'll be no return. This one will be out of the end zone. And so the Cougars will start from the 30 rather than the 20.
It's that rule again, you know, you're penalizing a kid who's got the great ability to put the ball out of the end zone. It's a great defensive weapon, and here you go, we penalize him again.
I still don't understand it. Somebody is going to have to explain that one to me. And we've even talked to referees about it, and they can't explain it either. So Mark Rippon comes on to see what he can do about getting the Washington State offense in gear. As you can see, they have a lot of offense. 431 yards a game. Most of that, as a matter of fact, has come in their last 5 games. Play fake this time, and Rippon will throw. Throws downfield, and who's got it? Nobody. The man who was closest to catching the ball was Tim Peoples. It was intended for John Marshall. Peoples made a great play, and there's a flag down back at the 20-yard line, roughing the passer. And so Washington State will get a break here. Ron Holmes might have been the guilty party. Let's watch.
Let's take a look at it here. Now, Rippon's rolling out. He's looking downfield for Marshall, coming back from left to right. He releases the ball. It's gone, and then he takes a late hit. Is that 90 in there, Holmes? It's a good call. Another good call by the official.
I don't believe it was Holmes. Let's give credit where it's due.
It wasn't Holmes. You're right. It was a Husky of some sort hitting late.
And that will bring it all the way to the 45-yard line. So the Cougars turned what could have been a disastrous play. It was very close to an interception as Peoples made a great defensive play on the ball into a break on the roughing the passer penalty. So they'll have it first down at the 45-yard line. Mays and Calvin all the way at the setback spot. Freeland in motion. 3 wideouts in the game now for the Cougars. And the pitch back to Mays. He's got room. 50, 45, out of bounds at 43. Bestie Jackson runs him out. It'll be another first down. Rick Chase, the man who gave him the clearing block.
Chase gave a good block, too. But I tell you, I like to watch Rippon when he lets that ball loose. You know, I keep looking at his helmet so he can pick up the defender coming in, but it's like he's got such great peripheral vision. That ball just shoots out of that right hand right back to his back, Reuben Mays. Great, great control, great fundamental.
Husky's playing an interesting defense right now, essentially going with only 2 down linemen as they bring Tony Lewis out and play 5 linebackers, but they do bring two of them up on the line. Interesting defensive alignment. We've seen a lot of it. This time straight ahead, that was Mays, and Mays doesn't get much. Steve Alvord there to make the stop.
They bring those linebackers in for those down linemen, Barry, and what it actually does, it gives you the same front, a 5-2, what they call an Okie, or a 34, which is the same. There are 7 men there. But what it does is it adds a little bit more lateral quickness to your defensive scheme because you've got linebackers playing instead of your 3-point down linemen.
We've talked about this Washington State offensive line on numerous occasions, and I think there you got a good indication of what they're all about. That was really essentially a nothing play, and it gained 3 yards. Offensive line made it all. 2nd and 7. Ball at the 40. Rippon play fake, in trouble, and down he goes. Was his arm coming forward? Incomplete pass. That will be the call there. Jim Rogers, the man who was coming on the blitz. And Rippon is lucky to get away with that one.
You got that straight. He never sees him. He comes from the blind side. He fakes with the fullback going. Here comes Rogers, 39. Look at him sneaking from the backside. Is the hand going forward? Yep. He's in the process of making a forward pass.
Once more, a good call, and now the Huskies do come with that other down line, and Tony Lewis comes back on. Rippon only 1 of 4 so far. 3rd down and 7. Big play for the Cougars. Mays goes in motion. Nobody left in the backfield. 3-man rush. Rippon hits his man. That is number 24, Chase, and Chase will be close to a first down. I believe he's going to have it. It's going to be very close.
Took a good shot from Meander, I believe it was in there.
It is a first down. They do have a whole bunch of people who can go get the football.
They actually do. Now watch right. He's going to jump the ball right in there to Chase. Now watch that. Meander's coming from the right side there. Gives it a good stick. Great form tackle.
We talk about how Mark Rippon has come on late in the season. He had 13 interceptions so far this year, but only 1 in his last 4 games.
It's a sign of maturity as a quarterback. On-field sight maturity, you want to call it.
Chase to the far side. James slots inside of him. And now they bring Mays in motion. Short drop. Pump fake. Rippon goes for it all. And goes too tall. Intended for Vince Layton, number 92.
Well, I'll tell you, was Layton, was he open? Holy smoke, was he open.
That was the same set they went to the last time, and then they threw that little slant. This time Rippon went the pump fake to the slant, took another two steps back, had his man open, just couldn't deliver the ball.
Gave a pump fake to the slant side, and Vestee Jackson took one step up, and that's all it took. When he took that one step up, 92, Vince Layton snuck right in behind him.
Second down and 10. Rippon 1 of 5, as we mentioned. Make that 2 of 6 right now. Mays once more out of the backfield. That's the same set again. Rippon with time. Throws. Open his burst at the 30. Tries to get by the first man. Can't do it. It'll be a gain of about 3. Vestee Jackson makes the stop. They'll give him progress just inside the 30-yard line.
Again, another solid tackle by 27. As you look at him, Vestee Jackson, the junior cornerback from Fresno. You know, he was in a one-on-one situation right there. Did what he had to do. He got a low center, a low base, stuck that helmet right up in the shoulder pads, made a very crucial tackle.
So a 3rd down and 7. That is exactly what faced the Cougars just a moment ago. They went to a slant to Chase. 3 wide outs in the ballgame once more. Michael James in the slot. And now he comes in motion. Make that Marshall in motion. James outside of him. Short drop, and this is Marshall. Marshall, first down, and Moore down to the 15-yard line.
Big catch by John Marshall. He wanted it, too. He was in motion here. We're going to get a chance to see him. Now, you watch him, 18, as he comes across. Watch him when he turns upfield. He puts both hands in the air and says, throw me the ball, throw me the ball. Right now, see? Give me the ball, give me the ball. He takes a shot, nice concentration, turns upfield, covers up real nice, boom. He gets hit pretty good by 26 Peoples. Big first down for the Cougars.
At the 15-yard line. Breland in motion this time. Rippon keeps, turns it upfield, gets the 10, gets down about the 8-yard line. Meander and Small make the tackle, but a well-executed play by Rippon.
He's a big guy. He's a nice guy to have running that option route like that. He's almost 6'5" tall, 218, 220 pounder. So he can afford to do that. Has a lot of strength, decent quickness, can turn up in the hole like that and get a lot of yards.
And 7 yards on first down. It'll be 2nd down and a long 3. 10-10 remaining first half. 6-0 ball game. The Huskies lead it. They've owned it so far. Burris comes in motion this time. Rippon counterplay to Mays. Mays at the 5, down to the 4-yard line. He'll be close to a 1st down. Joe Kelly makes the stop.
Now, we've talked in the past about Reuben Mays, and his biggest asset is hitting that hole so quick, getting up into that secondary, past the down lineman, and almost past those linebackers, where it forces the secondary to come in and make the tackles. He's the type of guy that can do that, and if he does it with consistency, he can play and run the ball a lot of plays because he will not take a physical beating.
It'll be 3rd down and inches. 5 yards to go for a touchdown. Mays and Calvin the setbacks. Breland in motion. Rippon keeps. Has the 1st down. So the Cougars all of a sudden getting in gear offensively here. How important does that roughing the passer call look now?
Oh, is that something? I'll tell you. Yeah, you don't want to turn the ball over. You don't want to goof up, stop a drive, keep a drive going for the other team when you have things like that happen.
On the Washington sidelines, Hugh Millen is throwing. I don't know if that's an indication that we'll see him or not. We will see. Meanwhile, it is 1st down, Cougars at the 4. Marshall in motion. And Rippon pitch back, fumble, I believe. There is a fumble in there. But the Cougars have it back at the 5-yard line. Fred Small, as Mays never really had a handle on that pitchback. Let's pause 5 seconds for station identification. This is the Pac-10 TCS Metro Sports Television Network.
This is KCPQ, the College Sports Channel.
Ball at the 5-yard line. It'll be 2nd down, goal to go. From the right hash mark. Chase in motion. And Rippon trying to keep, gets the shoulders turned forward, but the Huskies defense that very well. Kelly was the first man to mark Rippon. Rippon did get his shoulders turned around and turned it into a gain of about 3 yards. Cougars now will be looking at a third down and four to go for a touchdown.
Went from a one and a half, 2 yard loss into a 3 yard game. And that's because of the young man right there. You're looking at 17 is so big. He's big and he's strong. He's got decent speed and quickness.
6'4" and a half, 225 pounds, and he will be back. As will Mays. As will Kerry Porter, who started things this year as the number one running back. Slot left, big play. Rippon gives to Calvin, touchdown. Washington State Cougars, Jack, are giving Washington a different look out of that same set. They've come with about 5 or 6 different looks.
Well, they're varying their offense. They're showing them a different thing. They got guys going in motion, coming across. They're hitting them real quick. They're faking the ball in there to Mays. They're giving it to Calvin like that. You know, for example, on that last play, you thought one guy was going to get the ball down here in this area. It's going to be Reuben Mays, but he didn't. He gave it to Richard Calvin. A couple of times the quarterback has come down the line, faked the pitch, and kept it himself. Good variation, good mix-up.
Trout comes on to try to put the Cougars in the lead. This crowd is really something here. Snap, plays, kick, blocked! And it's a tie game. Tim Peoples blocked it. You know, one of the hallmarks of the Washington Huskies is they have always played brilliant special teams. Here's another example. As we watch the touchdown, we'll watch Calvin, and then we'll get a chance to see the extra point block.
You watch Calvin, 32. He goes right in over that left side where Dan Lynch, 58, Jamie White, 74, and then naturally the center, Kurt Ladinas.
So what a sequence of events. We got a tie game, and we'll be back right after this. Well, we want to remind you that coming up this basketball season, the TCS Metro Sports lineup will consist of some of the best college basketball in the East. We'll feature the Big East Conference, the defending national champion Georgetown Hoyas. In the Midwest, it's the Big Ten Conference, along with the top independents, Notre Dame, Marquette, and DePaul. And in the West, of course, it's the Pac-10 Conference. Plenty of basketball coming your way on the TCS Metro Sports Network. Paul Sicaro on the sidelines, talking it over with Hugh Millen, who was warming up just a few minutes ago. We have got a tie football game. Peoples with a big block on that extra point. Jim Alden a little bit disconsolate. He's got to be pleased that his team scored, but on the other hand, they did not convert. And here is a little bit of razzle-dazzle, and the Cougars have it back. What a play! It's like a flying wedge.
Well, I'll tell you what, it looked like a herd of locusts coming across the 50-yard line there. Let's see, who's, oh, they're going to give it to
they
the Huskies.
They gave it to the Huskies. Now, let's see, it did not go 10 yards. Is that going to be the rule?
I think so. It's got to go 10 yards before the Cougars can recover. Let's see what happens right here. Here's the pooch kick. Let's follow that ball. Look at that. Look at that. It looks like a greased pig that they're all trying to get. Does it cross this? Nope. There it goes. They make some contact with the ball before it goes 10 yards. It's automatically dead. Goes to the Huskies.
Well, we said we thought we might see a little bit of razzle-dazzle on special teams, and we did right there. It came within a half yard of working. As it is, however, Washington has the football in Washington State territory. Just across the midfield stripe at the 49-yard line. Slot left, Green in the slot. We never really did talk about the interesting matchups in this football game, that the strength of Washington State, of course, is the offense, which you saw taken in for 6 points a moment ago. Strength of Washington is the defense. If there's a weakness on either side, it's the opposite. So the matchups are most interesting.
You just flip the coin. You got the number one O in the conference going against the number one D, which is the defense, which is Washington. And then you just, as Barry said, you flip that baby over the other side of the coin, and that's what's going to have to make or break it for these two teams.
So far, special teams have told a big part of the story. Sicaro straight back to pass. Flag is down. Robinson on the screen tries to turn it inside. He's surrounded at midfield. It'll be a loss of two, and we'll see what the flag is. Lee Blakeney, the man who made the stop, and that's an excellent effort to turn Robinson inside.
That's such good quickness, and he's pretty strong to get outside and force him to come back inside. That's good hustle by Lee Blakeney.
Motion is the call. And the question is now, will they take the penalty? And let's take a look at some scores. Surprises all over the place. UCLA beating USC 29-10. It's got to be tough to play two emotional games in a row, but you've got to hand it to the UCLA Bruins.
That's unbelievable. Congratulations to Terry Donahue. A great ball game for his Bruins.
Oregon, perhaps the most on-again, off-again team in the Pac-10 Conference this year. They overwhelmed Oregon State today, 31-6. And what they call a big game down in the Bay Area, always a sellout. Stanford beats California 27-10. They trail 10-0 at one point in that game. Tough season for Joe Capp. At the midfield stripe, Sicaro back to pass, big rush, throws as he's hit, and Green makes the catch, and right in his face is number 51, James Krakowski. Brent White, the man putting the rush on Sicaro. Tony Roten was the receiver on the play, not Green, I beg your pardon, 88-80.
A little fake in there to 28, Jack Robinson. Boom, boy, I tell you, he just has to get rid of it. 73, I think, as Eric Hard came in. Now watch where Krakowski puts the hammer down there on 88, Tony Roten.
So it'll be third down in a bunch. About six, seven, perhaps. Sicaro rolls out to his left, throws downfield, has a man, Lonzell Hill out of bounds, first down, 35-yard line. Lonzell Hill made an all-pro move there, coming back to the ball.
He did. He came out of his break in a straight line. The ball was a little bit short. He came back to make sure he could catch that ball, thus not letting the defensive man get a hand in there to break it up. Comes from good stock, though. I mean, he's got great, he probably had a great teacher to look at number one, Lonzell Hill.
I would say so. No question about it. His father, of course, J.D. Hill. Played at Arizona State, played at Detroit, played at Buffalo. Roten comes in motion this time. Sicaro gives to Robinson. Robinson gets it to about the 32. It'll be a gain of about 3 yards. Brett White and Eric Howard make the stop defensively for Washington State. Six to six football game. A strange six on both sides.
It really is. You would think with the amount of times Washington had the ball and the turnovers from State that they would have more than just two field goals to show for it.
So they split Roten to the left side this time. Up in the tight end spot. Go on a quick count. Sicaro will throw. Looks downfield. Throws too long. Intended for Jones, 84. The tight end, Ricky Reynolds, was defending, but there was no way Jones was going to catch that football. Tony Roten was wide open on that play. Sicaro did not see him. We'll see if Burke doesn't go. He was talking to Sicaro just a moment ago. This time, however, he was up on the right side in the traditional tight end spot. Sicaro, play fake, or rather goes to Robinson. I fake me. Robinson in the open, took it all away. 10-5. Touchdown, Washington. Jack Robinson off a well-executed play by Paul Sicaro. Walt Hunt, the leading block for him.
It's a great run here by Jock Robinson, number 28. Let's watch it right here. It's just a little delay. Come back up inside, get some good blocks. And watch when he breaks into the secondary. He's looking downfield for his blockers. Makes a great move right there on two. Gerald Waters comes back up inside, utilizes his blocker as outside receiver, number one, who is Lonzell Hill, and scores a touchdown. Great running by 28, Jock Robinson.
So Jack Robinson, 14 carries, 78 yards. And the touchdown, Lonzell Hill comes off injured, 32 yards on the touchdown run by Robinson. Looks like Hill might have just had his bell rung. He appears to be all right. You get the cobwebs out. You've been there, haven't you?
Well, that's what happens. They say receivers don't do a lot of downfield blocking, but there's a good example as you look at number one, Lonzell Hill, come off the field. Great blocking downfield.
Jager will try to put the 13 point up. Snap, place, kick. This one is good. 5 minutes, 47 seconds remaining to be played here in the first half. Been a most interesting first half. Washington on a 32-yard touchdown run by Jock Robinson has gone into the lead, 13-6. We'll be back. Folks down in San Jose, he has just run 32 yards to put the Washington Huskies in front, 13-6. Jager will come on to kick it away. We want to remind you, at halftime, we'll have highlights of the first half, scores from all around the country. We'll look at the Pac-10 conference race, which has now been won by USC, despite that loss to UCLA today. Well, the national rankings are going to take a beating, aren't they?
It looks like a colander full of noodles to me, I tell you. I don't know who's going to be pulled out of there first.
Everybody lost. BYU's got to be dancing in the streets, I'll tell you that. Jaeger will be kicking it off. He'll be kicking to Junior Tatatasi. He hasn't had a chance yet. I doubt that he will this time. This one will be out of the end zone also. It'll come out to the 30-yard line. So Jaeger with a lot of leg on both sides of the field. Wind is not at all a factor here. That was all Jaeger.
Interesting, though, the last time that the Washington Huskies kicked off and the Cougars took the ball on the 30, they did drive 70 yards to score. Let's see if they can do it again now. Keep on the field. Keep that Washington State defense on the field. Wear them down. Get them a little bit tired.
There's a look at how the Huskies did it. It was following that onside kick attempt, remember, 6 plays, 49 yards. It only took them a minute and 49 seconds. That comes as very good news, I'm sure, for Don James and his coaching staff. He was concerned. Play fake, dribble to throw, airs it out. Open is Marshall. He's got it. Hit it on the way. 10, 5, touchdown, Washington State. How do you like that?
I love it. I told you they were going to score. I told you they were going to come back and score.
There is a flag down at the 13-yard line. So hold everything. I'll tell you, that flag, if it's a clip or a hold, could have nothing to do with that play.
We'll have to wait and see, but I agree with you. If it is,
it's going to go against Washington, I believe. 70 yards on the pass play. I believe the flag, personal foul against Washington State. They signaled it against Washington State, which would mean it was after the touchdown. Now we'll see.
Let's take a look at it again right here. Now Rippon's dropping back. He's going to look to his right and come back to his left. You're going to see 18 John Marshall come in from the left side, top part of your screen. Runs a great post route on 26 Tim Peoples. Gets in behind him, the free safety. Now it's a foot race right here. Watch him hold the ball up. Touchdown. Way to go, Cougars.
Remember, he had him beat once before, too. Let's talk about that flag for just a moment. What that was for, I believe, was that the Washington bench was on the field cheering.
I think so. There's no question. So they're going to give him the play. It's a personal foul after the touchdown beyond the kickoff.
It'll be assessed on the kickoff. That's right. So, meanwhile, it'll be Trout, the triple point. Place, kick, this one he gets up, and good. We're going to tie ball game just like that. This is turning out to be everything that it was supposed to be. Remember, we saw this play once before. The man was open. Rippon didn't get the ball to him.
Exactly,
here he did.
Exactly. He came back a little bit later in the ball game in the first half. Watch Marshall. Marshall's having a great year for the Cougars. He sneaks in behind the free safety. That's about his 31st, 32nd catch of the year. He's doing an outstanding job in his fifth touchdown this year. Great ball control type receiver.
Well, at the end of the game, we're going to be selecting an offensive player of the game. I'll tell you, we have our choice of about 10 right now. That award sponsored by our friends at Nissan. We thank them for their support of Pac-10 Conference football. Quite a ball game, 13 all. That was the longest touchdown pass of Mark Rippon's career. And you have an idea, his career, for all intent, is just beginning.
That was a great pass. That's what you call a touch pass. The good quarterbacks are the ones that can lay that ball out there and hit their receiver in stride when he's open. It's a more difficult pass than it looks, Barry. It's not the kind of pass you just throw it as far as you can. You got to put a nice touch on that ball and lead him pretty good. And there's no question about it. Rippon did that. And let's take some credit or give some credit to Marshall also, because he ran a superb route.
So Trout will now have to kick it off from the 25-yard line. The penalty for the bench coming onto the field, a personal foul penalty, has been assessed, as you mentioned earlier, on this kickoff.
Look at the linemen up to see what they're going to do now again. You never know what these Cougars are going to do in their kicking game. It's going to be suspenseful all evening.
I look for a lot of surprises. Trout comes forward, kicks this one away. Line drive kick, takes a big hop. And Lonzel Hill has trouble with it. Now he takes it at the 12, 15, 20. Looking for a place to go. Trying to get outside. Flags all over the place. And he's down at the 22-yard line. Very good coverage by Washington State. We'll see what the flags are.
Maybe some unnecessary extracurricular activities going on down there about the 40-yard line.
I think Mark Rippon has answered the question of what effect the cut on his hand will have on his passing.
None whatsoever.
Huskies are going to be penalized here. Blocking below the waist, I believe, is what that was. So this one's going to come back, and after having kicked off from the 25-yard line, and I'm sure the Huskies counting on having good field position, they'll be all the way back at their 12-yard line.
You're right, illegal blocking below the waist.
So the Huskies start at their 11-yard line. Cookie Jackson in the ballgame now. Robinson takes a breather. Slot right, Green in the slot. And now in motion. Jackson. And nothing doing. Rico Tipton and Junior Tupuola there to make the stop. Tipton's made a couple of big defensive plays for Washington State.
He has. He's played very well so far the first half of this ball game. The linebackers have also done a great job. The other linebackers, Lee Blakeney, Tupola has had a big play right there. Kukowski's looked good. And the linebackers on both teams have been doing an outstanding job.
So it'll be second down and 8 now for the Huskies. Huskies jumping all over the place. And the Cougars jumping all over the place defensively here. Pitch back this time to Jackson trying to get outside. And he does. At the 15 to the 20, it'll be a first down at the 27-yard line. Gerald Waters runs him out of bounds.
We had a clip there on number 19, Mark Patterson, coming back down the line of scrimmage.
We're about to say it was a good block by Patterson. It was a little bit too good.
Well, it would have been a good block till I saw the flag, you see, Barry. But as soon as the flag comes out, automatic, it's a little late.
Holding is the call, not clipping. And so that run for the first down by Cookie Jackson will come back. And right now, after Washington got all the breaks in the early part of this football game, they're starting to even out.
They are, and the defense of the Cougars is getting a little bit tougher. What they want to do here now is they want to hold the Huskies down here inside the 10, 15-yard line, force them to punt and get good field position, come back on with Griffin and the rest of the crew and put another one on the board.
Well, we started to say a little bit earlier that the Cougars would have to really play outstanding defense to win this football game. The simple fact is, even though they are last in the conference in defense, they've played two solid defensive games back-to-back.
They have. They looked outstanding the last 2 weeks, but they've got to have it tonight. They've got to do a good job and shut down the Huskies' offensive tack.
And it should be pointed out that the Washington Huskies are not either Oregon State or the University of California. They're looking at a much better football team. Here's Jackson, left side. Tripped up back at the 2-yard line. Jeff Doolin made the play.
Doolin read that very, very well. Took on a blocker, shedded him. Came off the blocker, made the tackle. Outstanding job by 26, the strong safety, Jeff Doolin. We get a chance to look at it again right here. Just a quick pitch right here. The 25, Cookie Jackson. You're going to see Doolin over there on the right-hand side. He's fought off a block, comes in and submarines Cookie Jackson, takes him down on the 2.
So it'll be third down now and 19 from the 2-yard line. Counter play this time. Jackson, the ball carrier, gets a little room, gets it up to about the 15, gain of about 13. It'll still be well short of the first down, and the Huskies will have to give it up, but they won't have to punt from their own end line.
Big play right there. I'll tell you, Dan Arnese, the center, got a great block on Rico Tipton, number 98, to spring Jock Robinson.
Well, I tell you, I've rarely seen a crowd in a football game as much as this one is here tonight.
You know, the people are, I don't want to say they're nuts. I mean that in an admiring way, because we were here about 1:15, 1:30, and there were hundreds and thousands of people sitting outside the stadium waiting to get in.
So Cleland will try it. Cougars show a 10-man front. Cleland will hit this at about the 5. And a good one. Twisted kick. Tough to handle for Blunt. And he doesn't handle it at the 35. And he still doesn't have it. Who's got it? Let's see. Mad scramble. We won't even guess. The Cougars say they do. And it's still being fought for under there. Cougars confident that they have the ball. And now the Huskies say they do. And the Huskies do. So the battle was won by Washington. And what a break that is for the Huskies.
Another great big break. It's tremendous. I mean, they've had the breaks. Now they've got to capitalize on this one again. They're down inside Cougar territory in good field position. No field goal now. They want to come away with a touchdown.
Try to get the man who recovered that. I believe it might have been Lonzel Hill. Not certain. Cougars now three turnovers. Turnovers have only cost them 3 points so far. Huskies, as you see, first in the NCAA in takeaways, 49 of them. And that one was forced really by Cleland kicking that very twisting 53-yard punt. Pitch back this time to Robinson, straight ahead, and nothing doing there. At the 21-yard line, Junior Tupuola and Brent White, the nose guard, make the stop.
Washington is not doing anything fancy. They're running that quick toss to one side, coming back, running it to the weak side, and all they're doing is pulling the big guards. Tim Burnham and Al Robertson are leading the sweeps.
And coming off the field injured, I believe, was Eric Howard, number 73 on the last play. We'll keep an eye on. He came off in some pain, replaced by Rob Cleveland. Second down, 11. Pitch to Robinson, right side. And he gets through a gap into the open down to the 12-yard line. He'd be close to a first down. He might have it. Gogan giving him a good clearing block up front. He might be a yard short of the first down. Jeff Doolin makes the tackle.
Watch it here now. Just a quick little hit, quick little toss. 45, the fullback. Walhunt's going to lead up through the hole. He's going to get the block by 72, Gogan. He sees it. He reads it very well. And before you know it, he's into the secondary. Good back, good running.
Yard short of the first down. It'll be third down a yard for the Huskies now. Sikora gives to Robinson this time, and he'll have the first down, I believe. It's going to be close, but I think he got to the 10-yard line. Minute and 43 seconds remaining to be played here in the first half. As you see, a tie football game. It has been an outstanding game so far. Robinson comes out. Festy Jackson comes back. First down. The ball just inside the 10. So it is first and goal. They will not be able to make a first down. Sikora pitch back to Jackson. Jackson looking for someplace to go. Gets inside the 10, about the 8-yard line, before he is stopped by Brent White, the nose guard. Gain of about 2 on the play. They'll mark it at the 8. And with a minute and 8 seconds left to play in the first half, we will have a timeout as Sikora comes to talk it over. 13-13 ball game. The Huskies driving. And this is Robinson at the left side, head down across the 5 to about the 4-yard line. Gain of about 4. It'll be third down and goal.
We're just working that right side. Milford Hodge, the right defensive end, and Jeff Loomis, the outside linebacker there. They're having a difficult time. They're taking on Walt Hunt, the fullback who's leading up through the hole. Dennis Maher, the left tackle, and Al Robertson, the left guard, doing an excellent job of blocking for the Huskies.
Sikora has asked for a timeout once again. And it has been an interesting football game so far. We want to remind you, January 3rd, it all begins. Tip-off game of the TCS Metro Sports Pac-10 basketball season. I'll have a chance to be courtside with Dan Belwamini and Corvallis when the Bruins of UCLA visit the Oregon State Beavers. So be with us all season long as the TCS Metro Sports Network brings you all the excitement and tradition of Pac-10 conference basketball. Robinson has now gone over 100 yards so far. He plays the big games pretty well, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's having a great first half, you know, over 100 yards from the first half. He may net 200 yards, which would be outstanding for the young man. Washington State, they can't afford to let him do that, though.
And Reuben May starting off very much as he did against California last week. He was at a very quiet first half, if you will. But then Jim Alden, when we were talking to him yesterday, was talking about Reuben Mays, and he said he'll get the quietest 100 yards you've ever seen.
He did last week, too. One of like, 113 or so. We didn't even realize it.
Alden on the sidelines trying to make some defensive changes, and now he's asking for a timeout. And will they get it? Yeah, they get it in time. So there is some defensive confusion here. As Walden wanted to get some substitutions in the ballgame, called for a timeout and did get it. Let's take a look at some scores from around the country. A day of surprises. And we'll be talking about who's number one. Well, you tell me. Nebraska was number one. They lost to Oklahoma 17-7. Oklahoma was number 6. They'll move up to be sure. but they won't be number one. Number two was South Carolina. They were undefeated going into today. Navy beat them 38-21, but it wasn't that close.
That's that spaghetti bowl effect again. I don't know who's going to do what.
BYU is number three. They are undefeated. They've won 22 games in a row now. They beat Utah 24-14. They had the struggle. Are they number one? I think you have to give it to them.
I don't know. We can talk about that.
How about Oklahoma State?
Now, there's a, you know, depending on next week, we'll see what happens with the Cowboys from Oklahoma State.
They struggled with Iowa State today. Remember, Oklahoma blew Iowa away, blew Iowa State away. Oklahoma State plays Oklahoma for the Orange Bowl next week. 16-10, they win their number four. They'll move up probably to number two, maybe to number one. You figure it out. Florida beat Kentucky 25-17. Strange, strange day. Meanwhile, it's third down and goal to go for the Huskies. Roten goes in motion. Sikora pitch. Here's a reverse. This is Green at the 10. And he is going to be stopped short at the 2-yard line by Ricky Reynolds. One-on-one situation for Reynolds, and the defensive man made the play.
It was a great job by Reynolds, 20. He came in and set himself very nicely and made sure he didn't cut back on him. Watch right here. You see Roten going in motion here. You pitch back to Robinson. You come back with Green on the reverse. You get a block from the quarterback right there. Well, just takes the linebacker out, but watch right here. Boom, there's number 20 sitting into Ricky Reynolds. Good job by Reynolds.
Here's another look at the same thing once more. They seem to telegraph this reverse just a little bit.
They did, but it still had pretty good execution. But the great thing is number 20, Reynolds, he stayed at home, as you say. He didn't follow all the way across field.
So the Huskies will try to take the points. Jaeger will come on. This will only be a 19-yarder. Snap, place, kick. Good. 51 seconds remaining in the first half, and the Huskies have put three more up. So Jaeger with three first-half field goals. But once again, the Cougars don't have to go off hanging their heads here.
No, they don't. They didn't give up a touchdown.
So Jaeger puts it up for three more. It's 16-13. The Huskies now have gone on top by three. It has been a most interesting football game. Turnovers have been something the story of the game. Cougars have turned it over three times. Huskies haven't. And that has been only a partial difference because of those three turnovers. The Huskies have come away with 6 points. The touchdown was on a drive. That following a onside kick attempt by the Washington State Cougars that failed by about a half yard. Washington State scored a touchdown. They had an extra point try blocked. It's been that kind of game.
It's been a good ball game. A couple of breakdowns here and there, but overall it's been a good ball game.
51 seconds for Mark Rippon and the Washington State offense. I would have to think, knowing Jim Walden and knowing Washington State and knowing Mark Rippon, they're going to try to get some points back here before the end of the half.
He's going to come out. He's going to put that ball in the air too. I'll tell you, they're going to put that. It's going to be filled with footballs in the air the second half.
51 seconds remaining in the first half. Jaeger will kick it off for Washington. Comes forward, bangs it away. End over end kick. Tatala Tassi may try this. No, he won't. He's about 5 yards deep. He will not try it. So Jaeger has been very much a hero for the Washington Huskies so far. He's kicked a couple actually out of the end zone, which you don't really want to do in college football now. There's the scoring drive. 7 plays, 19 yards. It took them 2 minutes, 22 seconds. Jaeger on the 19-yard field goal to make it 16-13. And the Cougars will start at the 20. Cougars, incidentally, really got their offense in gear. I'd say probably long about the UCLA game, which they lost their last play of the football game, but that was the first time they tried the option. Since that time, they've had the option as very much a part of their offensive arsenal, and the offense has really turned on to it. Rippon gives straight ahead to Mays. Mays gets into the secondary, gets it to about the 28-yard line. That'd be a gain of about 8 yards. Kelly and Krakowski make the stop. Dan Lynch, the man behind whom Mays was running.
It's a good example of we mentioned earlier about Reuben Mays. You know, it didn't look like it, but you realize he picked up 8 yards on that play. He was into that secondary by the down defensive lineman, almost by the linebackers before he could shake a stick at him, and that's what he does consistently.
That's what we were talking about again before, about how quiet he gets his yards. Mays has 57 yards in the first half, and really I don't recall calling his name that many times. So it'll be second down and three, kind of a free play for Mark Rippon here. Actually, second and two, really. Straight ahead this time, Mays first down to about the 33-yard line, and that may be the last play of the first half, actually. We'll see. They'll stop the clock long enough to move the chains, and we'll see if Washington State uses up a timeout or not. They have two left.
They can get two plays off, Barry, but they're on their own 33-yard line. That's a smart move. Let's just let it run out and then go in there and be safe.
That's what they're going to do. They are going to play it cozy and let the clock tick down here, and that's going to be the last play of the first half. So the Cougars do play it safe, and that is unlike, I think it's fair to say, a Jim Walden coach team for the most part. They will go in 3 points down. It's very much in this football game.
Your total yard pretty much equal, 218 to 191. Big difference is the turnovers. Three for Washington State, none for the Huskies, and that's the basic difference of the 3 points in the ball game.
And again, we talked to Don James yesterday about what the key to the game will be, and he said, well, we have to keep our offense on the field and keep their defense on the field. And as you saw, 7 minutes more of possession for Washington. There is a look at Hugh Millen, number 12. We'll see if he will be the quarterback of record in the second half of the Washington Huskies. So 30 minutes of football left. It's a 3-point football game. I don't have a clue who's going to win this game, I got to tell you.
You don't. You really don't. You should say, well, if you look at it, maybe Washington State may have the edge because of their...
It's very much in this football game.
Your total yard pretty much equal, 218 to 191. Big difference is the turnovers. Three for Washington State, none for the Huskies, and that's the basic difference of the 3 points in the ball game.
And again, we talked to Don James yesterday about what the key to the game will be, and he said, well, we have to keep our offense on the field and keep their defense on the field. And as you saw, 7 minutes more of possession for Washington. There is a look at Hugh Millen, number 12. We'll see if he will be the quarterback of record in the second half of the Washington Huskies. So 30 minutes of football left. It's a 3-point football game. I don't have a clue who's going to win this game, I got to tell you.
You don't. You really don't. You should say, well, if you look at it, maybe Washington State may have the edge because of their passing ability, but on the other hand, they've turned the ball over three times, and you can't do that consistently and win either.
Washington State, remember, has won this football game the last 2 years. Each time, Washington has come in as a favorite. The first time as an overwhelming favorite, and in the Rose Bowl at that time was a gimme for them, and Washington State beat them out of it. They beat them out of it again last week. And Tatalatas is going to have to come out now. And he gets it out to about the 10-yard line. That could have been a serious mistake. As it was, there's no box of chocolates.
Well, they're going to continue the emotion they did the first half. They're going to be sticking people. They're going to be pounding. You're going to be able to hear them hit up here. It's going to be a great second half.
Injured Washington Husky down on the field following that kickoff. Tatalatas fielded the ball at about the 2-yard line. And then just kind of had a mental lapse, stepped back into the end zone like he was going to take the touchback.
Trying to be cool, then you suddenly realize I can't do that. I got to get upfield.
Well, they got upfield for about 10 yards, so the Cougars will start things 90 yards away from the Huskies' end zone. As you look at the man who is down, we'll try to get an identification on him for you. He was in some pain a moment ago. One of the officials came over and made sure that the Washington medical staff got out there in a hurry, and they did, in fact, do that.
He may just have had the wind knocked out of him, Barry. I don't think there's anything real serious because he's not playing around with his knees or his ankles or his shoulders. He just might have had a lot of the wind gone.
One of the most uncomfortable feelings known to man.
You feel like you want to die. It's the worst feeling in the world. You can't. You try to suck a nice big gulp of air and nothing comes in and nothing goes out. It's terrible.
So while they tend to him, we will wait to get things started here in the second half. A lot of big plays in that first half of football. Statistically, some of the individuals in that first half, while we have a moment. Jock Robinson, 18 carries, 104 yards, had the 32-yard touchdown run. The man who is down for the University of Washington is Richard Barber. He's out of Oxnard, as you see, and he is still down, and they will take their time with him. Amongst the running backs, you mentioned Robinson, 104 yards. Mays has 58 yards on 12 attempts. One of those players who has a knack of being better in the second half. We'll see. The quarterback, Sicaro, who went all the way at quarterback in the first half. 9 of 13, that's impressive, but only for 87 yards. Through mostly to his running backs. And for Mark Griffin, 5 of 8 for 109 yards. Of course, the big play there, the 70-yard touchdown pass to John Marshall.
I think Barber's going to be okay, the young man who was injured. He might have got his belt in here, but he's going to be fine.
So the Cougars start things here, and the give this time straight ahead Mays, and Mays gets about three, perhaps. There's a look at the man on the sidelines who was injured. And he is talking to trainers. Still seems to be in a little bit of pain. We're going to try to keep him posted. May has got three on first down. It'll be second and seven. Ball just short of the 14-yard line. Jim Walden looking on. Normally very emotional coach, as we mentioned. His team plays that way, too. Emotion now Calvin And Ripon looks to throw that pass to Kalman, but it's a go, and Kalman throws into a bunch of traffic, and Meander had a hand on it, but he had it knocked away, actually, by Jim Rogers, the strong safety.
Exactly. They both had a shot at it. Rogers had a better view. He was going to come up with it, but Meander just bumped it away from him.
Now, that time, Ripon went with the play and probably was better advised not to.
I think so. It was a little crowded in there. There were too many white shirts, and he shouldn't have tried to put that ball there. As you look at it right here, he's trying to force up. There you go, three white shirts sitting in there. Three guys on defense can definitely cover two. There's no question of that. Two offensive players.
Ripon had set that play up earlier when he threw that out to Kalman coming out of the motion in the backfield. This time he pump faked it. Kalman went downfield. So too did the tight end Jamie Olsen. So it'll be third and seven. Ripon, play fake, pitch back to Mays. He's got room. 15 to the 20, 25 to the 30-yard line. First down for the Washington State Cougars. And a well-executed play by Ripon once again.
I tell you, it was fantastic. Also, a great move, too, there by 36, Reuben Mays. I mean, it looks like he was going to get knocked out of bounds. Put a little quick step and come back inside. Watch him right here now. Watch Ripon as he comes down. Watch his helmet. You never see him look at his back. He just feels him. He knows where he's at. And whoop, lays the ball right out there. Now watch Mays come back inside. Whoop, zips right inside the 10 peoples, picks up about 8-9 extra yards. Great running.
Fred Small going back looking for his shoelaces after that one. And you saw the numbers on Reuben Mays, 82 yards now. He's one of those guys sneaks up on you. And he will make the big play. Inside handoff, Mays. He got about five, maybe six that time to the 35-yard line. Let's pause 5 seconds now for station identification. This is the Pac-10 TCS Television Network.
This is KCPQ, the college sports channel.
Interestingly enough, Reggie Rogers, number 51, who's the starting outside linebacker for Washington, has not played in this football game. He is on the sidelines, and he does appear to be all right, and he is in the conversations with the coaches, but he has not played. In motion this time goes James, number 88. Quick hitter once more. It's Reuben Mays. Gets short of the first down. Flag is down. Steve Alvord makes the stop. And the Huskies pointing against the Cougars. Remember, Mays needed 92 yards coming into this football game to pass Marcus Allen. He has 82 yards right at the moment. That would move him into sixth place on the all-time list in the Pac-10 Conference. This one's going to go against the Cougars. And I believe it's going to be a holding call. And I believe it's going to be against Mike Dreyer, just to take it even one step further than that.
You got it covered. You got all the bases covered. Well, they don't want to have a silly penalty like, you know, as we've watched the referee give the holding call. You don't want to get a silly penalty to stop a drive, because they can move the ball against the Washington defense. There's no question that. But you can't do it if you have too many penalties or turnovers.
So it'll be second down and 14. Trips left formation this time. And now out of the backfield in motion goes Mays. Rip it straight back. Here's the blitz. Over the middle. Man is open. Marshall up to 35. It'll be short of the first down, about 4 yards, but a good completion of about 10 yards on the play. And the pass from Ripon to Marshall. Third catch for Marshall. Marshall might have had his bell rung a little bit.
It was a nice gutsy catch, too. He was the third man on the inside of that slot. And when you run a slant coming into where all the traffic is coming back out, you're asking for trouble. But great concentration by the young receiver. Big catch.
Same offensive set as the last time now. Trips left, three receivers to the left. And now Mays in motion out of the backfield. Ripon back to pass again. Four-man rush. Ripon throws. And open is James at the 45-yard line. And once more, you must credit Mark Ripon. He laid it right in there.
Great touch pass. Great touch pass. Nice route run also by Michael James. So one advantage that the Cougars have is they've got four real good receivers that they can utilize, shuttle in and out. You watch Ripon right here. He's looking right now. He's reading right through Marshall. He's reading down deep into James. Look at the pass right in between two Huskies in there. Nice pass, nice catch, big play, big first down.
Had to get that over the outstretched arms of a linebacker and still get it in there with enough touch that James could make the catch in traffic. Perfect pass. 7 of 11, 139 yards. Counterplay. Mays slips by the first man. Gets inside the 40 to the 39. That's vintage Reuben Mays right there.
That's right. Joe Krakowski had him in the backfield. Should have had him for a loss, but he took that leg out of that grasp of the defender, picked up 7-8 additional yards.
New Battleford, Saskatchewan. Very small high school. We asked Walden yesterday if he was surprised at how fast Mays has come along and matured as a football player. He said no, but I really think behind that smile.
Really, I'm with you.
Slot right this time. James in the slot. That's Marshall in the slot. Now he goes in motion. Three wideouts, and Cougars have gone with that most of the afternoon. Here's Ripon on the keeper. He's got all kinds. Risingly to the 30, 25, to the 20, down to the 21-yard line. J.C. Pearson makes the stop. Great blocking up front.
I'll tell you, it was a fantastic block by 18, John Marshall. You're going to watch it. Now, Ripon's going to fake in right here to 32, Richard Calvin. He can't go to his deep back. Look at the block by Marshall, 18 there. That's what's responsible for that 20-yard pickup.
Jamie White also sealing block.
Yes, White had an excellent job, no question. Good block. Jamie White, the left tackle, number 74, have been playing well all night.
Ball at the 21-yard line. First down now for the Cougars. In motion this time comes Chase. Give it to Calvin. Calvin slips through inside the 15 to the 14-yard line. Cougars very effective on the offense here in the second half. Remember, this drive started back at the 10-yard line. Mays now 93 yards. That will move him ahead of Marcus Allen. And you see what Washington State's done in the last four games, that since they started running the option.
That's right. They were scrounging around the first four or five games of the season. They got put together pretty good the last 5 weeks, and obviously their offense shows it.
Right now they've got Washington guessing. In motion this time, Burris, and Ripon wants a timeout. Now that's one of those timeouts that you have to say, well, if you saw something you didn't like, you didn't understand, it's okay. But it's one that you really might come to regret later in a close football
game. That's right. It may come back and haunt you with 3 or 4 minutes to go. Let's hope it doesn't.
10 minutes, 39 seconds remaining to be played. Third period, 16 to 13 ball game, and the Cougars are driving. No, the wave has started here at Pullman, Washington. No, Jack, it didn't start here.
Yes, it did. They told me that last night, that the wave definitely started here at Martin Stadium.
It has started in every stadium in the country, as a matter of fact. 16 to 13 football game. We want to remind you, at the end of the game, we'll be naming an offensive player of the game. That award sponsored by our friends at Nissan. We thank them. Meanwhile, the Cougars, with their offense really in gear, have it second and four inside the 15-yard line. Three wideouts once more in the ball game, and in motion comes James. Give this time to Mays. Mays gets it down about the 11-yard line. He'll be close to a first down. Offensive line of Washington State getting off very quickly right now.
There's no question. I was watching the entire left side. Kurt Ladinas, the center. Dan Lynch, the left guard. And Jamie White, the left tackle. They came off in good fashion that time. Got into the under the shoulder pads of the Washington Husky defensive down lineman and pushed him back.
Well, we have gotten news from earlier that Ron Holmes, the very fine defensive lineman of Washington, has been named to the Kodak Coaches All-American team, and we hear that it is very likely that Dan Lynch, who in some cases is playing opposite him, will also be named to the Coaches All-American team. So you've got two All-Americans, one a certain and one a potential All-American, playing head up on each other on some occasions. Calvin gets into the end zone, touchdown Cougars. John Breland, the lead block. Second touchdown for Calvin. They're not using them much, but when they're using them, they're effective.
Exactly. It's opportune play calling on the part of the Washington State coaches. Outstanding job.
11 yards on that one for the Washington State score. They move into the lead.
You watch Calvin here, now 32. Rich is going to run on the left side of that line. Again, in behind Lynch, White, and Ladinas, the center.
Stepped out of a tackle and took it into the end zone. Great effort by Richard Calvin. Second touchdown. Try for point. Drop. Snap. Place. Kick. It's good. And the Cougars have gone on top 20 to 16. That's a 90-yard drive, and that could be an indication of things to come. Number of players. Danny Green, I think, would be probably in the first two or three rounds.
I think so. He's got good quickness. You know, they may question sometimes his receiving ability or his flat-out speed, but he may be a good return man. Punt return, kickoff return, good backup receiver.
So Trout will kick it off. Here it takes about a three-step run-up. End-over-end kick. This one's headed for Green at the one-yard line. He has trouble finding the handle. Now he picks it up. Gets the five. Tries to get outside and does so at the 10. But that's all at the 13-yard line. Cougars moving to the ball.
Ron Collins hit him, knocked him out pretty good. Did a good job. You know, these guys get on these special teams, these non-starters, and they go banana. This is their chance to shine, and they do, and they do a very good job of it.
Here's another look at the execution of the Washington State Cougars on the touchdown run.
That's right. He lost the offensive line. They turn everything back away from the run. Back jumps inside in there. Richard Calvin takes out. Steps over, jumps up, scores a touchdown, everything's great.
Everybody did a job on that. You saw Lynch a little bit earlier in isolation. There's a look at the drive. It took 5 minutes. And Finney is hit by the first man. First man to him is number 51, James Krakowski. He was turned around and stopped by the rest of the Washington State defense. They're just making big plays left and right here.
Used a lot of time off that clock on that drive, didn't they? Awful lot of time.
Incidentally, Sikora is still the quarterback. It is not Millen, as we suspected it might be. Trimble starts in motion. Give this time to Robinson at the right side. Bumps off the first man, doesn't get much more. Washington State is fired up right now. Tipton and Howard make the stop. They've both been very dominant on the defense.
They have, and I'll tell you who else is going to get very dominant in this game before it's over is this crowd. You can sense that they're coming alive. Now, they have the lead. Granted, it's only a four-point lead, but they do have the lead, and the defense of the Cougars is starting to play very, very well and shut down Washington.
So it'll be third down and 7. This is a very big play for both teams. Huskies, they sort of feel a momentum losing here. Sikora back to pass, puts it up out of the backfield. That is the tight end. Roten, he's nailed by number 26, Jeff Doolin.
Listen to that crowd. I tell you, they're becoming more and more involved. So are the linebackers.
Howard was the man putting good pressure on the quarterback, Sikora. He had a lofted over Howard. Got it to the tight end, Roten, but right in his face was Jeff Doolin.
Doolin made a nice tackle. Hit him very, very sharp, very crisp tackle.
Roten comes off a little wobbly. Huskies, incidentally, only 2 of 11 in third downs. We'll watch that. Cleland comes on to do the punting. 10-man front. Let's see if they come after this. They do, and then they back off, and they'll play run back. End of a end kick, and Blunt handles it at the 29, to the 30, to the 40. He's got room. Midfield gets the outside. He's at the 40, and down he goes at the 39-yard line. Cleland, the punter, made a saving tackle for Washington.
Boy, he did. I tell you, it was a great run back by Blunt. If Cleland doesn't make it, he's still running. Here they go. Here goes the momentum.
A little bit of a windmill dance for Washington State on the sidelines. Blunt, the big return. He had one last week, too. 7:46 remaining, third quarter. Cougars have Mo on our side. 20-16. We'll be back.
Just for the fun.
Return by Ed Blunt. And that puts Washington State in business at the 38-yard line. And the crowd literally started to tear up the bleachers here. Rip at the quarterback. Play fake to Mays. He'll go up. There's an offer Marshall. He's in front. Touchdown, Cougars!
What a route. What a route the young guy ran. What a route Marshall ran. He ate Bestie Jackson up. I mean, literally just ate him up.
And once more, Rip would put the ball right in his hands. He went to the play fake. Washington has really been taking that fake from Reuben Mays. They've got to respect Mays. And they showed him Mays early in the second half. They've really taken the play fake on two occasions.
You make that play fake and it holds those linebackers and those cornerbacks. Just for a second, it freezes them. Mentally, it freezes them. Maybe not physically. And by that time, Marshall was into the secondary, and boom, he was gone for touchdown. Great route, great pass.
Just like that, the Cougars have gone up by 8. They'll try to make it 9. It's 26-20, I beg your pardon. Scoreboard shows 28. It was 26-20. Now they change it. Drive the point. Snap placed on this one. The holder never got it down. I don't know if it was the snap from center or the hold, but for some reason he never got it down. Trout had to take that stutter step. He never got to the ball, so it will remain 26-16. And once more, that opens the door a little bit. Very big difference between a 10-point game and an 11-point game.
It does. Watch it right here. Now watch Rippon. A little play action fake in there to Reuben Mays. Comes back, looks the opposite way, then comes back weak side, and there's Marshall. Boy, I tell you, he beats him by 3 yards. That's a great route by the young man. Also, Southern California receiver, I might add, too.
And guys. Also, Rippon threw it where the only guy that was going to catch that ball was Marshall.
That's right. It was a great pass. You're right. You're right. Even the fact that he is from Orange County makes no difference at all. It was a great, great catch, John.
He threw it to the sideline. No, threw it to the outside, so that man was not going to make that catch. If Marshall wasn't going to make it, nobody was going to make it.
That's right. It was a great, another touch pass. If that ball's put over the outside shoulder of that receiver, the only thing that can happen is he either drops it or it's incomplete and overthrown. It's not going to be picked off.
This crowd of 44,000, I believe. Now, there he's everywhere, I'll tell you. Bob Uecker becoming a bigger and bigger star.
Bob who?
Great seats, huh?
Yes.
The crowd to a number on its feet. Trout will kick it off. Two touchdowns here in the second half, and the Cougs have opened up a 10-point lead. But two missed extra points, and you know how costly they can be. Lonzell Hill won't try it. Huskies will start at the 20.
Now this is going to be a very, very important series for Washington. Granted, there's 7 minutes and 41 seconds left to go in the third quarter, which is a lot of time left to play in the football game. But from an emotional standpoint, you got to get something going here on this drive. Washington does.
Right. They got to come away with a couple of first downs, I would have to think. They have not had a first down here in the second half. Sicaro, the quarterback. Patterson, near side. Green, far side. Jock Robinson, the upback, playing in front of Rick Finney. Play fake. Sicaro will throw. Screen for Robinson at the 15, at the 20, at the 25-yard line, out of bounds. Jeff Loomis runs him out. Dan Arnese with a good block.
I'm not wasting any time about keeping that ball on the ground. I'm going to get in the air real quick and let's see if we can move it down the field. I know darn well that's what the coach Don James wants to do. Let's get it moving downfield. Gary Pinkel, his offensive coordinator.
Get a five on first down. It's second and five. Slot right. Pitch to Robinson. Robinson trying to get outside. He's tripped up at about the 23-yard line. He'll lose a couple. Rico Tipton, the man who made the play once more. Help from Brent White and Eric Howard.
I might add, too, that the guy who really turned everything in was Jeff Dulem, number 26, the strong safety. He made a very nice play. You'll see him come up from the upper left-hand top side of your screen right there. There's Jock. You see, now, he won't be in on the tackle, but what he does is he messes up Robinson's, the way he's running. He's got to force him to cut back inside right now. Here comes Tipton, comes in there and lowers the boom, number 96, Lee Blakeney.
Remember, the Huskies, 2 of 11 on third downs, and here they have another one, third and long, 7 to go for a first down. Somebody jump, we'll see. I believe it might have been the Cougars. If it is, it will be a gift 5 yards for the Washington Huskies. Third and two, of course, a whole lot easier. It is against the Cougars, and it will be 5 yards marched off against them. It'll move the ball up to the 28-yard line, but more important, instead of a third and seven, it'll be a third and short, third and 2 yards to go for a first down. We got Larry Thompson's microphone working a little bit here. So it's third down, actually about 2.5. Three tight ends in the ball game now, and the back split for the first time. They give it to Robinson, and I don't believe he got it. He stopped short. Lee Blakeney, 96, makes the stop. And now we got a little fight going on here. And a flag is down, but we'll see. This very likely will just be one of those, you're at fault, the other guys are at fault.
A little pushing and shoving going on. I think Rico Tipton was in there. I didn't see him hit anybody, and I didn't see him get hit, but you could tell by the way his helmet was bobbing. He was offering the other players some holiday wishes.
So we'll see. Personal foul against Washington State. And it is against Washington State only. And that really turns an outstanding effort by Lee Blakeney into... not a disaster exactly, but a first down for Washington, and that's the kind of thing that really changes momentum of a football game.
It should be fourth down right now, and it's not. And they get, and plus they pick up 15 yards. It's like anything you say, you always see the second guy, and you know somebody had to initiate that.
Now what you didn't hear there was an addendum to that. Rico Tipton has been ejected from the football game.
Well, that's going to hurt now. That's
and really that really, so it's not only the 15 yards and a first down, but they lose the starting linebacker replaced by Titus Jackson. We'll see. Very serious mistake. Serious mistake. Sicaro starts to fall, but he catches his balance, and he can't quite find Tony Roten with a pass. Here's a look at Rico Tipton. He has been ejected from the football game. So he cost him 15 yards, cost him a first down.
I'll tell you what's upsetting him, too. The thing that's upsetting him is he did not throw the first blow. Unfortunately for Washington State, he was detected throwing the second blow.
That's happened to so many players. They always see the reaction, not the action. Straight ahead this time, it's Jock Robinson. And he is cracked down as he got across the 45, about the 46-yard line. Milford Hodge and Lee Blakeney make the stop, and Blakeney really starting to take on some of the responsibility here.
He's going to have to. You know, Titus Jackson has come in and played Rico Tipton. Titus is only a sophomore, hasn't played a whole lot this year for the Cougars, but he's going to be expected to do a big job now.
And once again, it is third down and a bunch. Third and six for Washington. Normally a passing down. Sicaro, 11 of 16. Straight back to pass. Throws, has a man, and that's Patterson. Out of bounds at about the 38-yard line. First down for the Huskies. And just like that, the Huskies have started to change things around a little bit.
That's right. You see, as you mentioned earlier, the momentum has started to swing just a little bit. It's all caught because of that unnecessary roughness penalty. Look at it right here. Dropping back. This is Washington State. They're going to play a little bit soft in the secondary, and that's what allows them to make this pass. 16, Cedric Brown, the left corner for the Cougars. He's going to play soft. Let him catch everything in front of him, but don't give up the touchdown deep.
That's Patterson's first catch of the afternoon. He will make a big play on you. Normally a possession receiver, but he can go. Green starts in motion now. Huskies on the move. This is Robinson, and Robinson trips a little bit. That will be after. I'm sure that will be after. We'll see. No signal yet. And now they say the man was down before the ball shot loose. Titus Jackson made the stop on him, so that will be good for the mental side of Titus Jackson's
game. Absolutely.
Game.
Titus is now a part of the team. If he's gotten knocked down, he's made a tackle, so here we go.
Ball at the 38-yard line. What it does allow Washington to do offensively now is double up a little bit on Blakeney because of the inexperience alongside him. Green comes in motion to the outside. Play fake, and Sicaro will go up. Throws downfield. That's Green, and he can't quite hang on.
He led him a little bit too much. I would think if Sicaro, Barry, you know, can't put that ball on the money the rest of this quarter, I wouldn't be surprised if we brought Hugh Millen in because he is a better percentage passer than Paul Sicaro.
Coming up at the end of the game, we will be selecting a defensive player of the game. That award sponsored by our friends at National Car Rental. As you can see, the Cougars just running it up here in the third quarter.
Almost 100 yards difference there in total yardage.
A 15-yard penalty, of course, is really what has made this Washington drive. Ball at the 38, third down and eight. Straight back, Sicaro looks downfield, has a man again. It's Green. First down, out of bounds, the 24-yard line. So the Huskies have now made two big third down plays in a row.
It's a nice route and a nice pass, too, by Paul Sicaro. Laid the ball out there very, very nice. But we said earlier now, the Cougars secondary, they're going to play soft. They're going to be off a little bit. We look at it right here. It's an out pattern. The number 80, Danny Green, you can see. The defensive back for the Washington State Cougars, Ricky Reynolds, number 20. He's playing them off 12, 14 yards.
Jack, we talked about the students tearing up the stands. If you look over on the far side, I mean literally tearing up the stands. They're passing seats down the aisles.
It's too much.
Trimble in motion now on first down. And Sicaro will go up, looks the end zone. Trimble, touchdown Washington. David Trimble off the motion was wide open for the score.
We're in a zone coverage in there in Washington State. He found the seam, stuck in behind number two. Gerald Waters was wide open. A great pass. Excellent touch by Paul Sicaro.
And just like that, Washington jumps right back into this football game. It has been that kind of game. Tremendous game.
Let's watch it again here now. Sicaro's going to drop back. He's looking to his right. He's staying all the way with 23 Trimble. He leads him very nice. You're going to see two Gerald Waters come over. He just can't get there quick enough. Just can't get over there to knock it down. Good route, good pass.
Huskies will go for a two-point conversion here. They'll try to make it 26-24. Sicaro, the quarterback. Two tight ends. Straight back to pass. Looking to the end zone to Sicaro. Jumping around. Trying to find a man he can't. Manor got a hand on the ball. Was Junior Tupuola, number 54.
Big
and isn't
play.
It interesting how extra points may tell the story of this football game.
It really is. We're, you know, a point here and a point there, and nitty-picky, and here it is. Look at it right here. You watch Tupuola, as he comes in, he's going to get that hand of number 54. Big play right there. Big play.
That's a great play. So it's 26-22. We've had three missed extra points in the football game for various reasons. We'll be back. That's the Washington Husky band looking on. Their team has just scored. Went for a two-point conversion, failed on that. 26-22 football game, 4:39 remaining, third quarter. Washington will kick it off to Washington State. So Tatatassi stands back at the goal line. Crowd collectively still on its feet. So Tatatassi will not take this one. It's in and out of the end zone, and the Cougars will start at the 20-yard line. Starting to be a little bit of a track meet, no question about that. Well, coming up this basketball season, we want to remind you that on the TCS Metro Sports Network, we're going to line up with the very best in college basketball. In the East, the Big East Conference, defending national champion Georgetown Hoyas are in that, of course. In the Midwest, it's the Big Ten Conference, along with the top independents, Notre Dame, Marquette, and DePaul. And out here on the West Coast, we'll be, of course, covering the Pac-10 Conference. Should be a wide-open race in the Pac-10. And speaking of wide-open, Washington State offense has been wide-open this second half. They start at the 20-yard line. Griffin. Play fake, rolls to his left. He'll run the football. Gets the 20, gets to about the 24-yard line. Gain of about four. Wasn't quite sure what he wanted to do there. Tony Lewis makes the stop defensively.
He wanted to go to John Marshall on the corner route, but he couldn't. He used good discretion. He didn't put that ball up, it would have been picked off. He pulled it back down. Got what he could get before Tony Lewis, 95, brought him down.
Rippon, 8 of 12. He's only put it up 12 times, but 177 yards and two touchdowns.
A 170-yarder, that adds to your total.
That
makes
helps.
You look real good.
This time it's Chase to the near side. And James to the far side. And in motion now comes Greeley. Huskies jumping around. Play fake again. Rippon keeps again. Gets it up to about the 29-yard line. It'll be about a yard short of the first down. Meamber and Fred Small make the stop defensively for the Huskies.
You see the Huskies do a lot of jumping around down there on the field. What they're doing, you'll notice that what they're doing is they're doing it after the audible has been made. You're looking at it right here now. Rippon fakes in there to the fullback. He's going to slide down the line of scrimmage. Now he's going to break back up inside of number 90, Ron Holmes. He gets hit pretty good there. Stuck by five, Fred Small. But he's a big guy. He can take it.
Falls forward also. That's another thing Rippon and Mays both do with great consistency. Slot right, Marshall in the slot. Here's the blitz. Gives straight ahead to Mays. One man from breaking it. He's at the 34 with a first down. And I mean, that was a shoe-top saving tackle.
Nick Krakowski had him. I tell you what, if Krakowski doesn't grab him by the shoelaces, he's off to the races. Another touchdown for Washington State.
It came with a blitz that time from the weak side. Mays now over 100 yards, 101 yards for Reuben Mays. There again, one of those quiet 100 yards.
You never know it. You just wouldn't know it. He's just quietly successful.
So a first down for the Cougars now. Slot right this time. Still three wideouts in the game. Give it straight ahead to Calvin. And Calvin grinds it up for a gain of five, a little bit more than 5 yards. Tim Meamber and Joe Kelly make the stop once more. Got to mention the offensive line. Those are the guys that never get the marquee, so let's give them a little bit. Jamie White, the left tackle. Dan Lynch, left guard. Kurt Ladinas, the center. Kirk Samuelson, the right guard. Mike Dreyer, the right tackle. They're doing a job. 5 yards again on a play where there was really very little activity. Richard Calvin has been a big play guy, as you can see. Four touchdowns versus Washington the last two seasons. He's got two today. Second and four. Chase in motion. Short drop. Chase can't hang on.
They were successful with that in the first half. In the first quarter, to John Marshall, picked up a very important first down on that same play. This time he throws the ball behind Chase just a little bit.
So it'll be third down and four now for the Cougars. Cougars, two possessions here in the third quarter, two touchdowns.
Long ones, too.
38 yards. On the backfield, Mays in motion. No setbacks now. And here's Mays on the reception. First down at the 45 to the 48-yard line. Cougars have not been caught in that set all day long.
When that back goes in motion like that and he gets outside, what that does is that will stretch the secondary out. We're going to watch it right here. Now, just remember that you got that guy in motion. You lay that ball out there real quick. Boom, now you get him in a one-on-one situation, and that's what you want, is Mays in a one-on-one situation with a defensive back. Fortunately for Washington, Jim Rogers, 39, makes the tackle.
Really looking at a couple of pretty good running backs in this football game. Jock Robinson of Washington, Reuben Mays, and Richard Calvin, for that matter, of Washington State. Both of them, the kind of guys, never get stopped by the first man. Calvin straight ahead. Gets to midfield. Gain of about two. Might not have had the handle on that one. A little bit chilly. Temperature started at 41 at kickoff and have dropped perceptibly, I think, since that time. A lot of folks shivering.
The numbers are the same, but they're just in reverse order.
That's right.
About a half a dozen of us up here are doing a little shivering. Second down, about eight. Mays in motion out of the backfield. Short drop. Rippon looks, throws a slant. And that one intended for Leighton, the tight end. He couldn't hang on at the 40-yard line. They give you a lot of different looks off that same set. We talked about that a little earlier.
There's so many things you can do. You know, you can run the option. You can come down the line of scrimmage, pitch that ball off your trailing back. You can start out, you take a false step like you're going to run the option, and you pull back, roll the other way, and you come back like you did to Marshall for a touchdown. Just so many things you can do. Plus, you got to have the personnel, which Washington State does.
Nickel defense for Washington State here. Straight back to pass. This time goes Rippon. Looks downfield. That's Chase. Intercepted. Stepping in front was Ron Miles. Well played defensively by Miles. Miles was the nickelback. And Rippon, I'm sure, would like to have that one back.
No question. I don't even know if he saw Miles on that, because he threw it right to him.
So the Huskies started at the 35-yard line here.
Watch it again right here now. Rip, there he goes. He lays that ball right in, and it goes right to Miles. Miles is the first guy you see come into your picture. He's throwing right into that zone. You don't want to do it. You got to read that a little bit quicker.
Only the second interception in the last four games, actually four and a half games, for Mark Rippon. Green comes in motion now as the Huskies try it again. They trail by four. Out of the backfield, Robinson. Robinson, rather, Jackson. Jackson gets the 38-yard line. Gain of about three. Ricky Reynolds, Titus Jackson, converging on the ball very well. That is the role of a secondary player. Once the ball's in the air, you go to the ball. Some teams do it better than others. Numbers on Cipro so far, impressive.
They are. You know, they're just a little less than 10 yards per completion. That's pretty good.
High percentage. And this time it's Robinson. Robinson turns it upfield, gets it to midfield. Good effort that time. They execute that play very well.
Robinson is a read runner. He reads very well. He's constantly moving. You know, and it's a shame that he didn't have he's having the year that he had when he was a freshman. And we'll watch him right here. He gets in the line of scrimmage. Now watch him. He's starting to move to his left. He's going to come back to his right. He's always moving. Not going to go back to his left here in a minute. Boom. Good running. Good running. Of course, he got good blocking too by the offensive line.
Didn't get the ball over either. Dangerously close to coughing that one up. Cicero now. Play fake. He'll put it up this time. Throws over the middle. That's Lonzel here. He's got a little running room. He gets the 35. He gets the 30. 25 to the 20 out of bounds at the 19-yard line.
He's quick. Boy, is he quick coming across that field.
And it's the Huskies who are making the big plays right now.
Ron Collins, 25, had a shot or tried to catch him and couldn't. No way he could catch number one Hill. He just went right by him.
Lonzel Hill from Stockton, California, went to Stagg High School. He's just a sophomore. He's going to get better. Hard to believe.
Yes, but definitely.
Just 32 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. Huskies on the move again. This is Robinson. Robinson gets the first step, gets by a man, gets inside the 10, down to the 8-yard line. It'll be another Husky first down. There is the story. 25 seconds remaining here. Third quarter, Don James is passive as he was at the opening kickoff. Saw his team fall behind, now sees his team threatening to take the lead again. Green near side, Patterson far side. Make that Hill far side. Cookie Jackson, the up back. This is Jackson, left side. 10, 5, and down about the 3-yard line. Ricky Reynolds makes the stop. Walt Hunt getting that lead block once more.
Another fine defensive play by the right corner, 20, Ricky Reynolds.
And we have a timeout taken right now, and we'll be back with the end of the third quarter, 26-22.
A slight reaction or effect on whoever's got to throw that ball into the wind in this fourth quarter, which will be Washington. Shouldn't be that bad because it's not really going too much.
Maybe a lot of offense.
Maybe about 80 miles an hour, I'm not sure. You look at the offense, 364 yards for the Cougars, 345.
Flags in the corner of the end zone. I'm blowing up a storm right at the moment. It was not a factor at all before. Meanwhile, goal to go. And taking the ball out is Robinson. He'll be close. Did he get in? No signal yet. I believe he's short. It'll be third down about a yard. Huskies going with three tight ends in the football game right now. They go with Roten, Jones, and Faria. Don James on the sideline once more. Professorial looking. Ball's the 1 yard line. 26-22. They come to the line of scrimmage once more. A yard from a touchdown. Crowd on its feet. Robinson, he's there. Touchdown for the Huskies. Robinson running over the right side behind Tim Burnham and Kevin Golden. So Jock Robinson, second touchdown. Pretty impressive numbers for him so far today.
27 carries, 134 yards, two touchdowns. Good afternoon's work, I'll tell you.
There's another look, nothing fancy, just got the job done.
Right up there in the seam, look at that. Good blocking by the offensive line. He goes right up underneath the defensive left. I think it's Eric Howard, number 73, and scores a touchdown.
And Washington is back in front.
Another look at it from the sideline, Cam. That's a good angle. You see him as he squirms and wiggles his way in there.
Try for point, Jager up and good. 14-15 remaining in the football game. Washington has gone in front, 29-26. It's one of those games that just drains you emotionally.
It does. It's very, very difficult to keep a high emotional pitch through a whole ball game like these kids have had to do when you consider they've been doing it or trying to do it for the last 11 ball games. It's very, very difficult.
I'll tell you what, that unnecessary roughness penalty on Rico Tipton, when you look back on this game, should the Huskies go on and win it, has just had a profound effect, because since that point, the Huskies have taken it all away.
Exactly. That could be the, probably, it may be the most crucial play in the entire ballgame as we look at Jock Robinson. Say hi. Hi, Mom. There you got you. Way to go. Way to go.
Second touchdown. Second time he's had a chance to say hi to his mom. So Jager will kick it off. Interestingly enough, they have Millen on the kickoff team. That is Miles on the kickoff team, number 12. They have two number 12s. Very confusing, I'll tell you that. End over end kick. Tatalatasi will let it bounce out of the end zone. The side of the end zone, so it'll be a touchback. Come out to the 20-yard line. Washington moving the ball very effectively on the offense. Their offense has really jumped up and done the job. That last touchdown by Robinson culminated a 65-yard drive. Took 2 minutes and 20 seconds. Robinson took it in for the second time. Huskies with a conversion, lead at 29-26. And the onus now goes back on the Cougars, really.
Absolutely. Now they've got to sustain another drive, get back into the ballgame. They looked pretty good about 8-9 minutes ago. Now all of a sudden they're on the short end of it again.
Slot left, Marshall in the slot. And now in motion. Keeper by Ripper. He turns it upfield, gets about three to about the 23-yard line. Joe Kelly in the middle makes the tackle.
You notice how quiet the crowd has gotten for Washington State. You know, we talked about it towards the end of the third quarter, how much of it, a part they played in the success of the Cougar offensively. Now look what's happened. Washington has maintained possession, scored a couple touchdowns, and the crowd is very, very quiet.
The team has gone flat, the crowd has gone flat. Gain of three, it'll be second and seven. Slot left once more. Get inside, and nothing doing there. Steve Albert was there to really put it to Richard Calvin.
The flag down, Barry. We may have a holding call inside there.
That's one of those holds you wish you had back, too.
That's right.
If you're going to hold, you may as well at least make it on a big play. So this will march the Cougars back even more. Let's take another look at that, see if we can find what happened in there.
Let's look and see if we can find the holding. Flag comes in a little bit late, so maybe a very, it's a late call, but I can't see anything. There you go, right there off to the left. Whoever, somebody might have been holding there. Tony Lewis looked like he was held.
So it'll be second down after the penalty, but second down and 15 for the Washington State Cougars.
Well, that's good. The second 15, because now you know we're going to put the ball in the air. We're going to see those receivers running great routes. Griffin's going to put that ball on the money.
Washington, which does not often play a nickel defense, is in the nickel once more. And with the two down linemen. This time it's Griffin keeping now, pitching to Mays. Mays a little bit of room, 25 to the 30-yard line. First down for the Cougars. Reuben Mays just turns it upfield. Again, making the first man miss him, and that's really the key to Reuben Mays' success, I think.
Absolutely. It's great, great vision, great feel. He just has a knack for knowing where that guy is or what he has to do. And the great ones like Reuben Mays, you don't think about doing it, you just do it. It's just something that comes natural. It's a good, natural, great reaction. Notice how I called that nice pass play, too, that they were going to
do. That was good, yeah. Numbers on Mays, as you see, 117 yards. He sneaks up on you. Counter play this time with Mays. The ball carry. Mays slips a man. That's Calvin. Calvin gets into the open for the moment. Gets it up the 48-yard line. Joe Krakowski makes the stop. John Marshall gave him a key block. You notice how often Washington State's getting key blocks out of their wideouts.
Well, they're taught that, and they expect to be downfield. You know, when you catch a pass, it's great, but I want you downfield to be in position. Not to knock the guy down, but in case he needs you, you're there. You watch right here, 32, Richard Calvin. He gets into the secondary very, very quickly. He makes one Husky miss right there, two Huskies. Now he's up in the secondary. You're going to see Marshall, 18, right there. Get in front of 27. Bestie Jackson. Give him a couple extra yards. Good hustle, good execution by the Cougars.
So another first down for the Cougars. Play fake this time. Rippon will go up. Try to find somebody. Now he can run. He did have a man open. It was Marshall on the far side of the field. However, I don't believe he ever saw him. There's a lot of arms in the way that time, and I don't think Marshall was the primary and probably was not even the secondary.
He wasn't. He wanted to go to Rick Case, 24, but Case was, he wasn't even past the deepest man for the Huskies. So Rippon did a smart thing. He just pulled the ball down and tried to get as much as he can and tried it at a later date.
And he got six. You see all the numbers on Rippon, 53 yards rushing so far. Rippon has just shown himself to be a very poised quarterback the last couple of weeks.
Did an excellent job of maintaining his composure.
Second down, a long four. Rippon, pitch back, fumble in there, and it's out of bounds. That's a big break right there.
Yes, it is. Woo! Close.
Mays has coughed up the football on three different occasions, despite going over 100 yards rushing for the sixth consecutive week.
Let's watch this again now. Let's see if Reuben Mays actually watches that ball all the way into his hands. He may be looking upfield just a little bit. The pass, the lateral is a little bit out in front. He can't get a handle on it when he knows he's going to get hit, so his concentration is gone. Washington comes in scrambling for the ball. 36, Joe Kelly gets to it, but he can't control it.
In fact, Izzy gained a couple of yards on that ball across the 45-yard line. They brought the 44, close to the 44-yard line. It's going to be third down and three for the Cougars. Marshall in motion. And Rippon gives inside to Mays, and Mays, I believe, has the first down, and it looked like there was a mix-up in there.
I was watching Dan Lynch, the offensive left guard for the Cougars. What a great block he just executed. Just a fantastic block on Steve Alford, number 93, the nose guard for the Huskies.
It's going to be a first down. I think they're going to measure, but I'm quite certain that he did get the first down.
It looks good. It looks like he's got it. There's no question of that.
Rippon and Mays actually bumped into each other. Mays did well to hang on to the football, and it was the block, as you mentioned, by Lynch that gave him as much as he got, because it was not a picture play, I'll tell you that.
No, so he got to the hole late, so you know you had to have a great block from your lineman in order to hold that hole open, which is what he got from Lynch.
So here is the measurement, and there is the first down by Plenty.
We could tell the officials, we told them there's no question that we had more than
That's
enough.
Right. Little side note to some of the goings on here. As you look at the first downs, they're practically even. A few moments ago, the scoreboard was exhorting the crowd, saying, do the wave, and the crowd didn't. I like a crowd that talks back to the scoreboard.
The crowd controls the stadium.
First down, Cougars now. Straight ahead, Calvin, and there's nothing there. Ron Holmes, man who made the stop. We have not called Holmes' number a lot tonight.
No, we haven't. He hasn't been a major factor, although he has done a lot of things that we don't realize. He stacked up a lot of the offensive blockers come at him. He has forced people to do different things than they have wanted to. Your name doesn't get called, but you're still very responsible for what happens.
And you tie up a couple of people, too.
Exactly. I saw he had a long piece of rope down there, and he did just that a couple of the offensive linemen.
Really? Second and 9. Ball across the 40-yard line. James in motion. Inside handoff this time, Mays, and well played defensively that time by Steve Albert, number 93, the nose guard.
He did. He played that extremely well. It's a heck of a battle going on there between Alford, the nose guard, Kurt Ladinas, the offensive center for the Cougars, Lynch, the left guard, Tony Lewis. I mean, there's a lot of games, little games going on down there on that field.
So the Cougars rather now looking at a 3rd and 8. And really out of field goal range here. Three wideouts once more, slot right. Griffin pitching back to Mays. The ball is batted in the air by Holmes. What a play Holmes made. That's a tremendous play. Now the Huskies are saying they have it. A lot of finger pointing going on. It's either going to be fourth down or it's going to be the Huskies' ball. Let's see.
It's going to be fourth down.
That was just a great play by Holmes. It was almost as if he's saying to us, I'll show you guys.
That's right. We could get that big mid up there and bat that ball around.
He was in the backfield before Mays was.
Let's watch it right here. There's a quick fake in there to the fullback. He's coming down the line of scrimmage. He tries to pitch it out. The ball's popped up into the air. Look, it's almost a direct handoff to Holmes going the other way. But I tell you, Rippon had great heads-up ability there and came back down with the ball.
That's just a great play by the All-American Ron Holmes. Miles is the deep man as Harper. Little pooch kick by Harper, and this could be a good one. And it is out of bounds at the 1 yard line.
What a kick.
I mean, they don't come better now.
What a kick.
That's a great punt by Harper. Yards, and that's not even a significant number, but the significant number is 1.
That's fantastic. You watch Glenn Harper right here. I mean, he's got this thing nailed down. It's on a straight line. It looks very, very nice. Watch that ball. It's going to roll out just outside to the right of that cone right there. What nice, great camera shot. Great shot. Look at that.
He putted that one like it didn't have points on it. I'll tell you that. 29-26, fourth quarter. We'll be back. Look at Ron Holmes. He made an All-American play a moment ago. So too did the punter, Glenn Harper. Knocked it out of bounds inside the 1 yard line. You can't get a better punt than that.
Absolutely no way. Look how close that ball is to the goal line. What a kick.
So the emphasis now on the Cougars defense. Likewise, the Huskies offense. They got to wedge it out of here. Sicaro sneaks for a yard or two.
If they're going to try and do it, they're going to try and move that ball. At least let's get it out to that 10, 11 yard line. So if we've got to punt the ball, we're going to have enough room for our kicker back there. We don't have to worry about the ball being or going out of the end zone or having him step out.
Coming out limping a little bit is Jeff Doolin. He's been a vital part of the Washington State defense. He's replaced by Ron Collins. Cicero got it out just past the 2 yard line. And he's going to put it up out of the end zone. Does so. That's Finney. And he makes the catch about the 5, gets to maybe the 6 yard line. Collins in the ball game for Doolin makes the stop on the fullback Rick Finney. So it gets him out from under the goalpost anyway.
Well, Collins is a 187-pound sophomore, and Finney is a 235-pound sophomore. Sophomore against sophomore, a little weight difference there. Good job by Ron Collins running out of bounds.
Splitbacks this time, and Cicero wants to talk it over. Sees something defensively that he either doesn't understand or doesn't like, and he'll go talk it over with Don James. So each team now has burned a timeout. Each has 2 left. There is a timeout on the field. 8 minutes, 35 seconds remaining in this football game. What a game. 29-26, the Huskies. Football season, but we'll do it anyway. Thursday, January 3rd. We tip it off in the TCS Metro Sports Pac-10 Basketball Network. The Bruins of UCLA visit the Oregon State Beavers, so we want to remind you to be with us all season long as TCS Metro Sports brings you all the excitement and tradition of Pac-10 Conference basketball. Meanwhile, it's Pac-10 Conference football. 2 fine football teams. And here is a big play. 3rd down and 4. The ball at the 6 yard line. There's a flag, and I think the Cougars are going to be the guilty parties. That's another big play. It's the second time, if it is against the Cougars, and I believe it is, second time the Cougars have been penalized in a third down situation like this.
That kills you. You can't do that. One of them led to a touchdown. Now they've got them down there in the hole. You don't want to let your opponent get out. Let's watch some movement right here. Sickrow's doing a good job. You see, now they could call that on Sickrow because of the head movement that he just pulled right there, but they didn't. They called against the Cougars, but if you watch that head bob the way he did right there, that was purposeful. Masterful job, too, I'm going to add, by Paul Sickrow.
And it's a first down, and that is three first downs that Washington has gotten by way, two by penalty, actually three by penalty. Rico Tipton getting the fight, being ejected from the football game. That was in a third down and long situation, and here we are again. The Huskies have a first down, and they have capitalized to their credit every time they've had a break like this. Pitch back this time to Robinson, left side. He has little room, gets the 10, and a fine play defensively by Ron Collins, number 25. So Collins, who has come on for Doolin, has done a fine job defensively.
Two big plays Collins has made. Two one-on-one open field tackles. Excellent job. We're going to see him again here. Here goes Jack Robinson outside. He tries to put a move on. Collins, 25, comes up in there, sticks that head right there on the numbers and wraps it around his upper body. Good job by Ron Collins.
Looked like Robinson was going to have a little bit of room. Instead, no gain. It'll be second down, maybe gained a half a yard. We'll call it second and 9. Sickler waits for traffic, throws the tight end Roten. It's good to about the 17-yard line. It'll be a gain of about 6. Lee Blakeney makes the tackle. It'll bring about a third and let's say 3 yards.
Tony Roten, the tight end, number 88, hasn't caught a lot of passes this year, but I'll tell you what, they've been very, very important passes. He's averaging 9 yards, 9.3 yards per catch, so you know they're in tough territory and in crucial situations.
They come to the line of scrimmage, another big third down play, 3rd and 4. Play fake, Sickerow will throw. Throws over the middle, batted away. Brent White batted away. That's another brilliant defensive play. Boy, they've been one after another.
I'll tell you what, the defense, it's just a great ball game. I mean, we keep complimenting the offensive lines and the defensive lines, but I'll tell you, everybody's playing superb. Watch it again now, 57, Brent White, who's playing the nose. He anticipates, gets his hand up there, fights off the center. Does a great job. I think Kevin, is that the center or Kevin Gogan or Tim Burnham?
I think it was Burnham. And the interesting thing is Burnham did his job. He had him out of the play.
He did. He did. He did a good job, kept him out of the rush, and White comes back and makes an outstanding play.
Cleland to punt it away. They'll play run back this time. A lot of hang time for Cleland. Blunt, fair catch at the 45. And Blunt handed the ball that time to the Washington man who was down in his face. So the Cougars will start at the 45-yard line. They trail by 3. We want to remind you to join TCS Metro Sports during the upcoming holiday season. We'll have a great bowl lineup for you. December 26th, it's the Freedom Bowl from Anaheim, California. And on December 29th, it's the Aloha Bowl from Honolulu, Hawaii. Both games start at 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 Pacific. So be sure and check your local listings for the station in your area carrying the Freedom and Aloha Bowls. Cougars start at the 45. Inside handoff. This fake this time. Play fake. Rip it will throw. Throws intercepted. That's Kelly at the 40, 35, to about the 33-yard line. Joe Kelly, the big defensive play, 5th turnover for the Washington State Cougars.
It's unbelievable, too. I don't think Rippon saw him. He threw it right to Kelly. He threw it right to him.
That's a big play.
Big, big play for the Huskies.
Richard Calvin was the intended receiver on the play.
Watch it right here. Now he's dropped back. He should be able to see him, but he doesn't. And there's Kelly right in the line of flight. He's got to pick him up. He's trying to go to the out, to 18, John Marshall, but Kelly jumps in there, number 36, picks it up.
That's a big play, and the Huskies have it. They come to the line of scrimmage now on first down. Slot right, Green slotted inside of Hill. Give it this time to Robinson. Steps over the man to the 30, gets outside, 25, to the 20, down to the 18-yard line. Let's pause 5 seconds for station identification. This is the Pac-10 TCS Metro Sports Television Network.
This is KCPQ, the college sports channel.
Joe Kelly on the bench being congratulated by his teammates after an interception. Very big play down to the 18-yard line. And now the clock starts to become something of a factor here. Cougars defensively must keep Washington out of the end zone. I think they could settle for 3. It's at the 18-yard line. Pitch back to Robinson, right side. Robinson to the 15, back to the 10. First down inside the 8-yard line. Tim Burnham with a great block to Spring Robinson, and Robinson cut it back against the grain very well.
Hey, Jock Robinson, he used his blockers. He read his blockers very, very nice, and he used 78 Tim Burnham to his utmost and cut right in behind him. You're going to see it here now. Robinson going to get the ball. He's going to start inside. Now watch him use 78 Burnham right here. He's going to set him up right there. It makes an easy block for Burnham, then cuts back inside and gets about eight extra yards.
Down to the 5 yard line. It's catching.
It's getting cold. My mouth don't work anymore, Curry, to be honest with you. Pardon me.
We're at the 5 yard line now for the Washington Huskies. Three tight ends. This is Fenny, the fullback, to the one. Huskies have played errorless football, and that really has been the difference in the game. Five turnovers for Washington State. Fenny took it to the 1 yard line. It'll be second down and goal to go from the one. So they'll have three shots to punch it in here. Penny leaves and Hunt comes on in the fullback spot. Robinson the up back. Three tight ends. Roten, Jones, and Perea for the Huskies. This is Robinson, and he'll be stopped short, I believe, unless he got into the second half, and he did. Touchdown, Washington. Third touchdown for Jock Robinson. Could be the kiss of death.
Again, nothing fancy, just good, solid, hard ball control type running. Use that offensive line, those big horses up there. Tell him you need to get a couple here and a couple there. Good running, too, by Robinson. No question that. You're going to watch right here. Fourier, you see him going in motion. Watch the line. 67, Al Robinson pulls out. He gets a good block in 45, Wall Hunt. And Robinson finds a seam. He gets stopped, but watch the motion. He continues to fight. Even though Lee Blakely, 96, is trying to stack him up, it's the second effort of Robinson that gets him in the end zone.
So the try for point for Jaeger, which would give Washington a 10-point lead. Snap, place, kick. Good. 5:42 remaining in this football game, and we'll see if Washington State has yet another miracle in its pocket. 36-26 the score in this game. The Cougars will have it back. The Huskies have played error-free football, and that's the difference. Jazz pacing it. 5 minutes and 42 seconds remaining in the football game. They trail by 10. We'll see some balls in the air. There's no question about that. Jock Robinson, 10 touchdowns in his last four games. He has just come on so well as a senior. Had a great freshman year, actually maybe just a great freshman game, that Rose Bowl game, because he really wasn't too prevalent prior to the Rose Bowl game. Had the great game in the Rose Bowl. He was the MVP, only freshman to ever be named the MVP in the Rose Bowl. And then he had two very off years. He went down, hung out with Marcus Dupree down in Mississippi, and simply said he got himself fat. Came back, wasn't in great shape, didn't have a good sophomore season, didn't have much of a junior season, and now he's come on and shown all the promise of that freshman game that he played in the Rose Bowl. This goes into the end zone. Tatalatassi will not have a chance at this one either. And Tatalatassi has had only one chance at a kickoff return. He only brought that back to the 10-yard line. So that part of Washington's game has been very solid.
Well, we're going to watch the Cougars now. Ripley's going to have to get back there, set up, and fire that ball. You want to get down the field as quick as you can. You don't want to take it all in one or two big chunks. But let's move it down. 5:42. What you really need is a touchdown and a two-point conversion to get you within a field goal. Plenty of time to do that. Let's just don't panic. Let's don't press. And let's make everything count.
So they'll start at the 20. Ripley threw an interception the last time. He's had two in this game. He had only one in the previous four. Pitch back to Mays. Mays gets into the room. 25-30. Tries to get outside. Gets the 40-yard line. A gain of 21 by Reuben Mays on first down.
I'll tell you what, that's what you call supreme confidence. When you're 10 points down with 5.5 minutes to go and you run that option, when you flip that ball out there, that's good confidence.
And we're going to get a penalty in addition. So we make it a late hit against Washington. Reggie Rogers, incidentally, is in the ballgame for the first time today, number 51.
And he got the penalty call on him, I think. We're going to watch it again here now. Again, we're going to option, come down the line of scrimmage here, flick that ball out there to Reuben Mays. There's Reggie Rogers, number 51. Look at Mays hit the hole. Trying to set up the defensive back, cuts back up inside. Gets good yardage. Now watch 51 on the lower left of your screen. Now we can't see it. You won't see what happens to him. But he's getting blocked and he doesn't like it. Of course, the guy blocking is only 5'9". That's why he doesn't like it.
So it'll be first down. And a big first down. A 37 yards on him over that one, he said and done. Griffin this time keeps the ball. He's got room, 35, and there's a trailer play, pitches it back to Mays, who gets down to the 23. Taken only 20 seconds so far. They haven't put the ball in the air yet.
Well, like I said, they couldn't get down there in two plays. They've gotten down this far in three. But I'll tell you what, it's a heads-up play. And that's what happens when the quarterback and that trailing back, that eye back, comes in there. They have played so much together. You're going to see it here. Watch Rippon right here now. He knows right exactly where Mays is. He knows he's going to get tackled. Look at the flip out right there, and there's Mays in perfect position. Great play.
Takes it down to the 25-yard line. Another first down for the Cougars. Calvin in motion out of the backfield. Pump fake this time. Rippon looks to the end zone. Throws deep for Calvin. Too far. He had him open. Threw a little bit too far.
He had Joe Kelly out there one-on-one. In a one-on-one situation, he had him beat, but the ball just a little bit overthrown.
Hey, we might have a guy with a slow hand on the clock, too. That play took 4 seconds. Walden on the sidelines, talking over with his brain trust. Sam Burris in the middle of that conversation. It's second and 10. Once more, Calvin out of the backfield in motion. Counterplay, Mays. And not much. He gets about three, down about the 22-yard line. Ron Holmes makes the tackle for Washington. Ron Holmes is just so quick.
Got good foot speed. You know, you like to see that first and second step. He's really moving almost. Sometimes it seems as he's moving at top speed after two or three steps. And that's what you want in a down lineman, to get that rush, get into that backfield, and create some havoc in there.
In a two, it's third and eight now for the Cougars. So a big play coming up here. They show blitz, and they come with a blitz. And this is Rippon on a keeper, and he'll be stopped well short of the first down. Now what do you do?
You go for it. Let's go get it anyway. Interesting thing in that last play, they had 90 Ron Holmes. They had him playing over Dan Lynch, number 58, the left guard. And we were told we weren't going to have that. We weren't going to see that.
And they are going to go for the three, I believe. That is exactly what they're going to do. So they'll take the three and then worry about the touchdown later. And the clock continues to tick down here. 4 minutes and 10 seconds remaining. It will be Trout out of the hold of Blunt. And you could think fake here also. Something to tuck away in the back of your head. They load up the left side. Snap, place, kicked. It's on its way. It is good. 3 minutes and 53 seconds remaining. The Cougars have got themselves within a touchdown here. And so now the pressure once more goes on to the Cougar defense. Washington has been able to move the ball. It's probably been Washington's best offensive game of the season. 3:53 remaining in the football game. Washington leads it 36-29. I think your point is well taken. You were talking during the commercial that they'll just line drive it down here. It's exactly what they do. Tough one to handle. Hill still hasn't got the handle. Now he finds it. Now he hits the outside. He's got a little bit of room. Almost broke that. Got it to about the 29-yard line. And a flag is down.
Late hit, maybe.
I think that's probably going to be it. Boy, penalties and turnovers have just crippled the Washington State Cougars here. Unnecessary penalties, I might add.
Yeah, exactly. Unnecessary penalties. You don't need those type of things.
So that's going to cost them. It's going to give Washington great field position.
Let's see what happens. And that may be junior Tau Talatasi comes in there, right there, 38. Yes, he does. There's no need for that. You don't have to do that. That's the way people get hurt.
He was trying to tackle a football is what he was trying to do, take the ball away from Lonzel Hill. So it'll be at the 43-yard line. Great field position for Washington.
Trying to take it away through his ear hole of his helmet, I think.
I think that's right, yeah. 3 minutes and 48 seconds remaining. The Cougars, incidentally, have only one timeout remaining to it. Green in motion. And a handoff to the fullback, Finney. And he gets a couple to the 45-yard line. It's almost imperative for the Cougars that they hold Washington without a first down here.
Absolutely, yeah. You want to hold them and get off that pile as quick as you can. Get back to the defense and let them wind that clock up. Let the referee, Larry Thompson, say, okay, let's play ball. Wind that clock.
Minutes and 20 seconds now, still ticking down. 7-point football game, and as we mentioned, the Cougars with only one timeout remaining. So they'll have to hold Washington hope to get it back with about a minute and a half left. Finney straight ahead again. He gets to midfield. It'll be third down and three. So the game pretty much rides on this next play. College football, of course, no such animal as the two-minute warning, so you don't get a gimme timeout. They have one timeout remaining, period. And the clock continues, of course, to tick down. So this is pretty much it. Cougars will have to hold here if they're to have a chance to get the ball back. Sicaro will go up with it. In a little bit of trouble. Throws downfield, man open. That's Roten. First down. Huskies at the 32-yard line. It was a safe pass.
It was a safe pass, and I'll tell you what Sicaro did. He wanted to go to number 80, Danny Green. Danny wasn't open. He pulled it back down, and he looked downfield. He maintained his composure, and here comes Roten. As we said earlier, Roten does not have a lot of catches, but the ones he does have are in very key situations, and that's a great example of that right there.
So the Huskies now, at least in theory, can run it out. And the Huskies, incidentally, we'll talk about it in a minute, as Robinson gets the call, he gets a yard, not much more than that. Huskies are looking at a major bowl berth now with all the goings on today.
I think so. You know, there's so many, I don't know if they're upsets, but there's so many games that teams lost that shouldn't have lost, or there were surprise wins, or teams who were out of bowl pitchers all of a sudden blasted somebody, and now they're back in bowl pitchers. Some, a lot of things were said last week about Washington after they lost to SC number one and didn't score too many points number two. Now they had to come in here to Pullman and try and play a fired up, you know, Washington State team who's looking for a bowl game also. So they're going to play. There's no question of that.
A minute and a half remaining. I'll tell you an interesting thing, too. We'll talk after this play. Sicaro this time gives off to Robinson, and he is stopped at about the 31-yard line. It's possible that the Cougars may get the ball back for a play or two. What I was going to say is just a week or so ago, everybody was talking about the Huskies going to the Rose Bowl. And down in the Orange Bowl, they were talking about South Carolina and Nebraska. Now we conceivably are looking at an Orange Bowl that would be the Washington Huskies and the Oklahoma State Cowboys.
That's right. Conceivably, you're absolutely correct. And wouldn't that be a blow? I mean, a lot of people, wait a minute, what's going on here? I'll tell you what, two fine football teams, no question of it.
Well, there's a timeout on the field right now with a minute and 13 seconds remaining to be played. The Cougars have used their last timeout. It's 36-29. Barry Tompkins and Jack Snow, and there you have a look. Number 28, kind of in the background of one of his big interior linemen, Jock Robinson. He is the offensive player of the game. Let's take a look at what Jock Robinson did. Did nothing more than score three touchdowns. I'd say that's a fairly good afternoon. Plus, he gained about 140 yards.
Three touchdowns, gained a lot of yards in crucial situations in a very big game. Definitely deserving of the award.
Jock Robinson, the offensive player of the week, sponsored by our good friends at Nissan. Meanwhile, it's a third down. And about 13. There's a minute and 13 seconds left. Washington State cannot stop the clock anymore. If they can contain Washington here, they might have two, maybe three plays. And straight ahead, great play right there by Hodge, as Robinson never got started. And so the Cougars will get it back. Cleland will come on to punt and just see what he can do. I'm sure we'll see another one of those little pooch kicks here.
I would think they let the clock, as soon as the referee winds, let that clock run down and take a five-yard penalty. But you're going to wipe off 20, there we go, you're going to wipe off 20-some seconds off that clock.
They'll have 23 seconds left, the Cougars will, to see what they can do about getting in this football game. And it's likely that they'll have at least 80 yards to go.
I would think so, no question about that. And the sad thing is that you don't have any timeouts. That's tough to do, is to move that far in this short amount of time with no timeouts.
Now, the Cougars have done stranger things, I'll tell you that. They will take this five-yard penalty here. It's a meaningless penalty, and there will be 23 seconds left. Cougars, of course, have already staged what was at that time the most dramatic comeback in college football history when they came back from 28 points down with 6 minutes remaining in the third period. They beat Stanford. This one would be an equal miracle. Let's take a look at the defensive player of the game now. He is Joe Kelly, the linebacker of the Washington Huskies. He's in there somewhere. Trust me on this one. 20 tackles and an interception for Joe Kelly. Quite an afternoon. That award sponsored by our friends at National Car Rental. Cleland sends this one end over end. And will it get to the end zone? I don't believe so. He got a great bounce that time, and it'll go to the 5-yard line. So the situation is this. If Jim Walden has another miracle in his back pocket, it's got to be a 95-yard miracle, and it's got to happen in 13 ticks of the clock. Well, we want to thank the whole bunch of people for their help in not only this football game, but all along the course of this Pac-10 Conference road trip that we've been on all year long. First of all, from the University of Washington, Athletic Director Mike Lude, the head coach Don James always takes the time to talk with us. Sports Information Director Chuck Niemeyer. For Washington State, their Athletic Director Richard Young, their head coach Jim Walden, the Sports Information Director Rod Commons. For the Pac-10 Conference, man is standing right behind us. In fact, the Executive Director, old friend Tom Hansen, Assistant Director, and our traveling buddy is Rippon. Still rolls away from pressure. He's got a little time. He's going to run. He's going to have to run a whole long way. I'll tell you that. Out of bounds. Saved himself 4 seconds for another play. Thanks to John McCasey, the Public Relations Director of the Pac-10 Conference, Jim Muldoon. Good folks up here in the booth. Tom Fick has been with us this entire season. I want to take a second, in fact, to thank you, Jack. It's been a lot of fun working with you. And I'm sure we will do this all over again, tee it up next year.
That's not what you said at dinner.
It's because you didn't buy.
That's 11 games in a row, Barry. I haven't had to buy.
You got another dinner tonight, pal.
That's true.
Meanwhile, the goalposts are about to go. On the far end of the field.
It's some oranges.
Oranges rolling onto the field. There are representatives, I believe you mentioned, from the Orange Bowl here, and it's looking more and more like Washington could be in the Orange Bowl game. Rippon in a whole bunch of trouble. And he's going to be sacked for possibly a safety. Yes, it's going to be a safety. And that's an inauspicious way to end the football game, but it's going to make Washington a 38-29 winner. Ron Hadley was the man who made the safety on Mark Rippon. Just a tremendously exciting football game.
Beautiful. I mean, it was fantastic. It's full of all the things you want to see in a college game. The crowd went nuts. Great fireworks. You know, and people are yelling and screaming. There's a lot on the line because of the outcome of the ball game. And you had two good football teams.
Nobody has left this stadium, even now that the final gun has gone off. A tremendous game. And the Huskies win it 38-29. We'll be back with a final word right after this. Here in Pullman, Washington, you look at the final scoreboard. A 9-point game really was a 7-point game. Safety on the last play of the game. There's the offensive player of the game. Jock Robinson, number 28, walking off the field. 38-29, the final score. Washington beats Washington State. Back with a final word right after this.
The Mitsubishi
Stadium in Pullman, Washington, 38-29 football game. Jack, I think it's fair to say it's another one of those football games where nobody really lost the game. But one team won it.
Well, you know, something happened today that I didn't expect would happen in this ballgame. Number one, Washington scored 38 points. Number two, I didn't expect 4 turnovers by the Cougars. The way they have come on the last 3 or 4 weeks, I thought for sure that they would be a little bit more solid. And least of all, that Reuben Mays wouldn't cough the ball up twice, nor would Rippon throw 2 interceptions.
Washington State showed itself a very solid football team also. We talked about the fact with Jim Walden yesterday that really 2 plays and this team is really looking at a 7-4 season.
Absolutely. You know, the SC game, the UCLA game, and, you know, they're right in the thick of the things. It amazed me, too, and I've got to give a lot of credit to Don James and his staff for what Washington went through last week to get blown out of not only the conference championship but also the Rose Bowl and come back and play like they did today. It's a real credit to his organization.
Fact is, his team is 10-1, and they could be looking at an Orange Bowl berth against the winner of the Oklahoma State game. A lot of interesting bowl developments, and we'll talk about those when we come back. Stadium in Pullman, Washington here. We have seen a very good football game between 2 very good football teams. Here's another thing that we should talk about, and you really want to point a finger at these people and say, great way to go. These are the academic all-conference teams. Every one of these players has at least a 3-point grade average, better than that, actually, in most cases.
I think there's only a couple, but the rest of them are like in that 3-4 to 3-7-5, 3-8 category, and that's outstanding for these young men.
We're just going through this list rather quietly for you, but they're really all names to remember. Emil Harry, who had a chance to be an All-American, had a little bit of an offseason this year. Must have had a big day today in Stanford's win, however. Tony Colorito, he's a guy very likely will go on playing the NFL. Same can be said about Dwayne Bickett. Talk about an all-around guy.
Outstanding linebacker, great student, Bob Huditz from Oregon. We saw him several times this year. Again, Matt Stoudeland from Stanford, outstanding student as well as a good football player.
You're looking at all student athletes. Ron Pitts, the son of Elijah Pitts. He's going to be around for another couple of years. Kenny Taylor at Oregon State. He's a guy who's thinking ahead, certainly the NFL, but also what am I going to do when all of this is over? So a group of outstanding athletes, student athletes, if you will. All these players, of course, are. Those are the best of the best. Here we had a 38-29 football game. Washington has beaten Washington State, they very likely are looking at an Orange Bowl berth. And we'll be back. Huskies, it's been a long road of Pac-10 conference football. Saw some very good football teams, and I think one thing that's particularly interesting, most of the players that we saw this year will be back next year.
It's scary. You know, for example, today you look at all these fine young men out here, the entire backfield is coming back for the Cougars. It's going to be a great year again in 85 for the Pac-10.
Really should be, and we will look forward to being with you then. So for Jack Snow, I'm Barry Tompkins saying, as we say in the television business, that's a wrap. Once more, the final score, the Washington Huskies 38 and the Washington State Cougars 29. This has been an exclusive TCS Metro Sports presentation.
Buying a
ballistics check yet, except that all of the other victims were shot with a 38, all were robbed of their welfare checks, all were killed in the afternoon. The ballistics on the first four match, I expect they will on this one.
Anyone with any information on the Southside killer should call our eyewitness hotline number, 555-4545. You don't have to give your name. The only possible lead reported by the police is two people who claim they saw a male Chicano leaving the alley at around 4:30 p.m. He is described as in his mid-20s, approximately 5 feet 8 inches tall, and slender.
Facts, say the experts. Join us as Northwest Afternoon explores the new intimacy of the 80s, Monday at 3.
Also, you'll learn what to do with the rest of that turkey after your family makes its first pass at the bird.
And I'll have soap news, reviews, and more on Northwest Afternoon, Monday at 3 on Como TV 4.
Como 4 News, news that counts.
Husky Football, brought to you by SeaFirst Bank. Expect excellence for all your banking needs at SeaFirst. And by the brewers of Mountain Fresh Rainier and Rainier Light, two great tastes in beer. And Rainier's Western Washington distributors. And by your local Puget Sound Honda dealers, where the quality goes on and on.
Good afternoon, I'm Bruce King. We welcome you to Husky Football along with Husky head coach Don James. As I'm sure most of you know, if you're Husky fans, Huskies defeated the Cougars by a score of 38-29 yesterday in Pullman. They run their season record to 10-1, and the first time you've had 10 wins during regular season play, I think in, what, 59 years, something like that? I mean,
it was 1925, and I really don't remember that year very well.
Team played very well. You were down by 10 points, 26-16. It looked for a while like it might be over, that you weren't going to be able to stop the Cougars, but yet you were able to stop them and get points on the scoreboard. Offense played well.
Both offenses played well. I think, you know, all the players played hard. I think that's one of the key things, and the offenses had a little better day of it, without a doubt. Their offense moved the ball, our offense moved the ball.
Starting the game 4 o'clock in the afternoon, 4:10, did that make any difference? Was it that cold, bother the game?
You know, I can't remember really a day that we've played the Cougars in the last 10 years. It was really much better. You know, the field was dry, there was an easterly wind, but, you know, it was more of a kicker's wind, not a...